Hi, WTAR. You have a suggestion or something you just want to talk about?
Yeah, I wanted to talk about education also.
Okay, I'd like to ask you one thing and get off the subject that you're on right now a little bit.
I think something good to talk about would be the legalization of prostitution.
Yeah?
For drugs, I would say legalize marijuana.
The lack of driving etiquette on our highways.
These telephone people that call and try to sell you magazines.
The Bruce Garraway Show, 9 to noon weekdays on AM 79, WTAR.
Welcome back to Scope, everybody. The opening night festivities continue on ice as special presentations are being made to Betty Den Decker and Alan Augustin. Betty was the lady who designed the logo, and picked the nickname Admirals, and Alan Augustin designed the new Admirals logo that is emblazoned on the front of the home jerseys, and special presentations have just been made to those two folks, and we thank them for their contributions to hockey in Hampton Roads. We will be having the introduction of the Hampton Roads Admirals here, and we'll be joining public address announcer Bill Bishop for those introductions.
Gentlemen, let's meet the 1989-90 Hampton Roads Admirals. Number 30, goaltender Alain Ramon. Number 1, goaltender Trevor Kruger. Number 2, defenseman Jordan Foy. Number 3, defenseman David Buckley. Number 4, defenseman Jody Presnick. Number 5, forward Steve Greenberg. Number 6, forward Don Gagne. Number 7, forward Chris Lukey. Number 8, forward Bobby McGrath. Number 9, forward Mike Black. Number 12, forward Murray Hood. Number 14, forward Dennis McEwen. Number 15, forward Chris Wheaton. Number 17, defenseman Mike Flanagan. Number 18, defenseman Scott Taylor. And number 19, forward Wayne Stripp. The Admiral's assistant trainer is Tom Pettit. Head trainer, Pete Rogers. Assistant coach, Kurt Breckenberry. And the head coach of the Hampton Admirals, Mr. John Murphy. So there they are, the 1989-90 Hampton Roads Admirals. The Admirals getting a warm reception here. Of course, when you talk about having a brand new hockey team, these fans are just cheering names. They don't know these guys yet, but they will. And I think they're going to like this team.
Oh, they certainly are. They've got a big group out there. This is the first time I've seen them other than a couple of practices. And they had some good size. I think the people of Hampton Roads from the days of the team here, the days in Hampton, are very familiar with hockey players, and they're going to make these people part of their own very shortly.
The Virginia Lancers have come out to their blue line, and they're clad tonight in the red road tops and the blue pants. The Admirals in the home white jerseys with the blue pants tonight. The starting lineups tonight for Hampton Roads. Starting in left wing will be Dennis McEwen. The center iceman will be Murray Hood. And in right wing, Don Gagne. Left defense, David Buckley. Right defense, Scott Taylor. And the starting goaltender tonight will be Alain Ramon, property of the Washington Capitals. For Coach Dave Allison of the Virginia Lancers, opening at left wing will be Greg Nisch. At center, Luke Vitale. And the right wing is Jeff Waver. Left defense, Doug Hobson. Right defense, Randy Taylor. And in goal tonight, a gentleman who was in this league last year had a 4.30 goals against average and a one-loss record of 12-11 with 5 overtime losses. His name is Steve Averill. And he'll be between the pipes to our left. And Alain Ramon will be tending goal off to our right. The referee is Brett Parsons, and his linesman will be Robert Payne and Jeff Prusik here. And our eye in the sky, of course, is Pat Shetler, who'll be keeping an eye on the action and also what the gentlemen in the stripes are up to tonight. So happy we are to have Pat joining our broadcast team for Hampton Roads Admirals hockey this season.
I don't think that any sport, whether it's hockey, basketball, baseball, you name it, there's a special feeling on opening night that really no other part of our culture can describe. Maybe Broadway, an opening night of a play, can describe it, but unless you're involved in sports, opening night is really something special.
It certainly is electrifying to come into an arena of any type, but on opening day, where the adrenaline is flowing from the players, the adrenaline is flowing to the fans, they want to see exactly what's going on. And I know Blake Cullen and Pat Nugent are very excited to see the amount of people that are coming in here, and they certainly are.
So the Lancers and Hampton Roads just about set, and the special presentation now is going out at center ice, and Mr. Bill Luther, the man who,
hey my boy,
has helped bring professional hockey to Scope, is going to be dropping the ceremonial first puck here this evening. So we're just about set for the opening faceoff here.
Well, the ice looks very good, Bob. They've always had very good ice here anyway, and in the past when they had the Red Wings team. The Zamboni is a machine that cuts the ice, it shaves it, it brings the shavings into a hopper, it melts it and puts it back onto the ice again, and that's what makes it so smooth. So it's just pretty glass clean out there tonight. And it makes a lot of difference for a hockey game, because if the puck is flowing on good smooth ice, it makes the passes more crisp. If it's bumpy and irregular, then you have the problem of the puck bouncing all over the place, and really the game, even if you have good hockey players, isn't played properly.
Well, that's certainly one advantage to playing in this building. This is a great building for the game of hockey.
Oh, it's tremendous. There's not a bad seat in the building, actually. It seems that most of the people are centering into the center area. It's probably the best place to watch a hockey game, are in the corners, where you can get some good view of the upper ice, and you can also get into some of that loud slam-bang action against the board.
The Lancers are skating off to our left, getting in their warm-ups, and the Admiral starters are out off to our right, and we should have the puck dropped here in just a moment. Lineups being introduced to McEwen, Hood, and Gagne up front for the Admirals, with Buckley and Taylor defensive, Raimondi in goal, Nish, Vitale, and Waver for the Lancers, with Hobson and Taylor at the bench, and Admiral in goal.
As you look around, Bob, you'll see different sweaters from the National Hockey League, whether it's the Buffalo Sabres, Montreal Canadiens. I just see one gentleman down there that has a referee sweater and a goal mask down in behind us. Well, that's a little bit odd, but
I wonder what team he's for.
He can't be for the officials, that's for sure.
That'd be a first.
That'd definitely be a first.
So the ceremonies at center ice are over, and referee Brett Parsons has come to center ice. Murray Hood will take the draw for the Admirals against Luke Vitale. And we're just about set to kick off the 1989-90 East Coast Hockey League season here at Scope, as the Hampton Roads Admirals meet the Virginia Lancers. This is Bob Rathbun, along with Pat Shetler, welcoming you to Scope and WTAR Radio. Glad to be a part of the Admirals broadcast this season. Parsons checks with his lineman. We're waiting for Dennis McEwen to come to the red line. He's set for the Admirals. Parsons to drop the puck, and we're underway, and the draw's been won by the Lancers. Back out defense, it is Hobson over to Taylor. The puck comes to the center ice, and it's taken away by the Admirals. Coming up, Murray Hood over the blue line, down the left wing. A centering pass, and that's broken up by the Virginia Lancers and Greg Nish. Now the Lancers try to clear it, and it comes to center ice, and the Lancers are in control. Luke Vitale with a rush toward goal, and Murray Hood, and it's tucked away. The Admirals defense, and they flip it out to center ice, and trying to run it down out there is Scotty Taylor. Now the puck is taken away by Waver of the Lancers over the blue line, controlled by Vitale. He centers a pass, fanning on the shot was Nish. Now the puck goes to the far corner, and the Admirals will take control there. Don Gagne with it for the Admirals, and he plays up toward the blue line, broken up by the Lancers, and they are able to keep it in, moving in a shot, and knocked down by the defense. Nice job that time by Taylor to smother that shot. Puck comes to center ice, and clearing it is Murray Hood. He dumps it into the zone. The Admirals will change on the fly as the Lancers go back to retrieve. 1 minute into the first period at Scope, Virginia and Hampton Roads, opening night of the East Coast Hockey League. The Admirals back on defense. The centering pass comes to Steve Greenberg, the 18-year-old out of Chicago. He takes it over the blue line, heads toward the corner, ridden off the play by Mike Cigasolo. Now we've got a hard smash into the boards, and the Admirals now dropping back as the Lancers control the puck. They come to center ice, and with it there is waiver for the Lancers of Virginia. The puck is shot behind the goal, picked up there by the Admiral defense, and this is Chris Lukey on the right wing. Pass comes to the blue line. The Lancers try to keep it in, and they do. Defenseman Thompson is there to pound it in. Now the puck goes to the far corner, and with it there for the Admirals is Buckley in the center ice, and again the Lancers are able to take it away. Hampton Roads having a little tough time clearing it out of their own end here in the first few minutes of this game. Now the puck to center ice, and it is taken there by Steve Herneman of the Lancers. He is checked off the puck at center ice by Taylor, and the Admirals try to rush. They get it ahead to Michael Black. Black carries it in. Here's the shot, and it goes wide, steered around the goal by Averill of the Lancers. Shooting at the goal to our left, and here's a quick hard check into the boards coming up, and a shot on goal and a save. The shot taken by Wayne Stripp of the Admirals, and a save by Averill. And now the Admirals try to keep it in, and they do. And with it is the centerman, Greenberg. He's tangled up. The Lancers trying to break it out, but can't get back in for Hampton Roads is Wayne Stripp. So the Admirals keep the pressure on. The puck comes to the blue line. The Lancers take it away, and they've got a rush. One-on-one. Here's a fake on the slap shot. Now a centering pass, and it goes underneath the state. Escapes of Chigasolo, and it comes to the wing. The Lancers are controlling in there in the Hampton Roads end. Now the puck is batted out of there by the Admirals' defense to the blue line. Admirals will change lines here as the defense. And with it there is Mike Flanagan firing it up to center ice. Now the pass is taken away by the Lancers. They get it to their blue line, and going in on goal is Denny Paul. He had the puck taken away. Now the Lancers get it back, and here's Thompson at the blue line. He dumps it in, and the Admirals will go back and play it behind Elon Ramon. 16:55 to go first period, and no score here at Scope. And here come the Admirals. They've got a 2-on-3, and firing it is Gagne, and a save by Averill. The puck rebounds to the blue line. The Admirals are able to keep it in. Everybody gets on side. Here's Gagne with a quick check into the boards to steal the puck away. Fires one toward the goaltender, Averill, but it's controlled now by the Lancers. They bang it off the boards. There to bang it in is Jordan Foy for the Admirals. Hampton Roads controlling at center ice. Going in is Foy. Beats his man. He's got a shot, and it's right into the chest. And a save made by Averill.
Well, it's been a long stretch there. We went about 4.5 minutes, Bob, and it's a long stretch without a whistle. The Lancers seem to be putting on a lot of pressure, their offensive pressure, and probably a lot of it is to do with them being a second- or third-year team. They have a lot of the players that they had last year, so they kind of know where each other are. And it did box up the Hampton Roads team a little bit. They weren't really as organized right then. But as the latter part came, they started to get things together. They had a couple of good shots on goal, and they had some good body contact. You'll notice on the far side there, they're replacing the glass. Remember that body check in the earlier part of that period knocked the glass out, but it's back in there again. And this sometimes happens, but they have a very good crew here at the Scope. And these people are Johnny on the spot when it comes to replacing or fixing up something that's caused to a body check on the board.
While there's a break in the action, we'll pause 30 seconds. You're listening to Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR.
Hello again, this is Tom Looney. Well, we're off for the weekend. The entire morning show gang sharpening their fangs for next week. Lots of things to do around the Hampton Roads this weekend. We hope you'll take WTAR with you if you go out. We're portable, you know. Monday morning, we'll have the WTAR news, weather, traffic, and sports. Of course, lots of good music for you. And in honor of Halloween next week, all of my jokes come from ghostwriters. See you Monday at 5 on WTAR.
Maintenance crew here is trying to fix that plexiglass in the far corner off to our left that came out of place, and they'll have that secured in just a moment.
One thing, Bob, about the boards have a little bit of give to them. They're not solid concrete, for example. They're braced plywood, and there is a bit of a give. So when a player is thrust against it, there's a little bit of a give there, so there's not a serious injury. But on the ends, they have the glass. If any of the fans that are listening haven't been to a hockey game, they have glass to protect the people at the end of the rink. It'd be a very dangerous area without that glass. And it is braced between two stanchions, and sometimes with a hard thrust to the boards, it rocks the boards, which that one did. Will displace some of the Lexan. That also is Lexan, which is an unbreakable plastic. So
you do find the odd time in the National Hockey League that a puck or a stick or a skate will go up and break the Lexan. It'll shatter. But it certainly, if you're in behind it, you're pretty safe.
Yeah, that's pretty rare.
Well, this gives both teams a quick break. It was a breakneck pace to start this game. As you mentioned, Pat, we went 4 minutes and 20-some-odd seconds without a whistle and a stoppage of play. Both teams changing on the fly, obviously. But it's rare when you go that long without even the puck going being frozen or being flipped into the stands or something like that.
Well, generally, in the first 4 minutes of a game, you'll have maybe an icing or two, or you'll have, because the players are a little tired right off the bat, and you'll have a lot of offsides. And very rare does it go right off for the 4 or 5 minutes the way that did. And it's hard on the teams because they're changing on the fly, and it's very hard for Brophy when he hasn't been dealing with these players all the time, just a couple of practices, to know exactly who to send and who not to. They really send themselves in most instances, Bob. He'll tap a center, and that'll mean if a left winger comes off on the fly, a left winger from the bench on the second line or third line will go on and replace him. So really, the coach is just tapping that center and saying when he wants a change, and then when he wants a change, they know when to change.
A couple of weeks ago, Coach Brophy was at the Norfolk Sports Club, and in the question and answer period at the end of the program, one gentleman stood up and says, "Is there anything that you hockey coaches do behind the bench?" Right. And Brophy says, "Well, we'd like to think so."
That's exactly right.
And out to the casual fan, so much is getting the lines organized, getting your power play organized,
right,
getting
exactly.
your penalty killers together. And and I think the situation at Johnson is so difficult because not only is he dealing with people he hasn't seen that much, they are also new to professional hockey for the most part, and they haven't been through this kind of a grind.
Oh, they are. It's very difficult. John Brophy is an excellent coach. I mean, he was a tough-nosed hockey player when he played in the Eastern League, and he went up through the American League. I don't think he ever made the National League as a player, but he certainly made it in another position that is very, very, very difficult to obtain, and that's the coach in the National League. And he coached the Halifax team in the in the American Hockey League for 2 or 3 years, connected with the Montreal Canadiens chain, and then he was with the Toronto Maple Leafs, and anybody that can work for Ballard, Ballard being Harold Ballard, with the Toronto Maple Leafs, is a good man. What's happening here now is very difficult on both teams, and difficult on the coaches, and extremely difficult on the fans. The fans want to get this thing going. We had a bit of a delay for the glass. Now the whistle is blowing, and I think we're going to be ready to roll again, Bob.
All right. We'd like to remind everybody, be sure to catch the Admirals at home all season long. They'll be back at Scope on Wednesday night, November the 1st, to face off against the Knoxville Cherokees. Game time is 7:30. Be sure to get your tickets early for the second home game of the Admirals' inaugural season. The faceoff will come to the right of Virginia Lancer goaltender Steve Averill, the faceoff spot to our left. Steve Greenberg will be in there for the Admirals. The puck is dropped, and this was won by the Admirals. Here's a shot on goal by Flanagan, and a sick save made by Averill. The puck to the far corner, and it is taken there by the Lancers. It comes to center ice, and Flanagan is there, waits for his mates, and they all get onside, and Flanagan dumps it in. Here comes a pass, and it's intercepted by the Lancers, and they head out with a head of steam coming to center ice, and with it there is Nish. He takes it in, and written off the play by Chris Lukey, the Admirals. Lukey goes to recruit the puck in the far corner. Now the Admirals trying to clear the zone, and the Lancers dump it in, and Randy Taylor does the honors. Alain Raymond behind the Admiral net to stop the puck, and now the Admirals bring it up. That one hopped over the stick of Lukey and comes to center ice, and it's picked up by the Lancers' Randy Taylor. He falls down as he comes to the blue line, and the Lancers are offside. Well, they had it timed properly, but they didn't expect Taylor to lose his skates and fall down, and that caused two linesmen to go offside. 15:40 left in the first period, and nothing. Hampton Roads and Virginia here at Scope.
Well, they're flying out there, Bob. Both teams are skating well. Their passing is starting to come together. The crowd looks good here. I don't know
what they're still coming in. It's going to be 6,000.
I would say so. It looks great.
The Admirals win the draw. Man to center ice. The pass goes underneath the stick of Bobby McGrath and picked up by the Lancers. The defenseman, Steve Chelios, has it. He plays to center ice, and Denis Paul taking it in. He gives it over to Nish on the left wing, and the Admirals poke and check it away, and now it comes to center ice. And again, the defense is back there to organize. Chelios plays to center ice, and it's picked up there by take a solo. He goes in on goal, trying to get a backhander off and couldn't. The defense there to knock it away. And the Admiral breathed a sigh of relief. Chigasolo, who just took that last shot, led this league in scoring last year with 45 goals. Here's a shot by Wayne Strick of the Admirals that is deflected and goes over the glass and out of play in a faceoff.
Bob Taylor, a very fine defensive play there as the Lancer was breaking in on the net. And he poke-checked the puck from behind him, and that's a very good play. You don't always have to put the body on everyone in this game. I mean, you can be fancy with the stick, but he was.
I know John Brophy is really high on one of his starting defensemen, Scott Taylor. The Lancers take the draw, and the pass comes to center ice. Taylor, the Admiral defense there to try to break it up. The Lancers dump it in. Raymond back to stop it behind the net. And getting it there for the Admirals will be Jordan Foy, new to the hockey club as of yesterday. Foy controlling behind the net. And now going back to deep Hall for the Lancers. He fights centering pass. No one there to accept it. And the defense going back to chase it back at the Lancer blue line. And Randy Taylor is there to get it. And now we've got a two-line pass. And a faceoff will come in the Virginia zone.
That two-line pass, an offside pass, Bob, that was shot from inside the defending zone to the other side of center ice, the other side of center ice red line, goes over the blue line and red line. The only thing that could make that legal, the puck crossing two lines, would be the player at center that takes it, has his feet on the line itself, has any contact with his feet on the center ice.
I've been studying that rule book.
Oh, yeah, Adrian. It's a couple.
14:33 left in the first period. Nothing here at Scope. The Lancers control the faceoff, and now they have it in the far corner. And Scott Taylor there to break it up for the Admirals. Nice check into the boards, delivered by Whitfield at the Lancers, and an equally fine check by Luke on the near side. The puck goes to the far corner. The Admirals are trying to control. Now the Lancers come away with it. Barry Nykar, he takes it behind the goal. Moves it out to the wing, and Dan Richards. And Richards is knocked off his feet by the Admirals, and the pass now comes to center ice, and Nykar, he'll play it off the board. What ran past the puck, and it is going to be the Admirals that control the center ice. Now the Lancers steal the puck back. They come down the wing, and with it is Denis Paul. In on goal, and a shot to save by Raymond. In the slot, and a shot, and the defense breaks down with a good play by Lukey that time. Now the Lancers controlling. Hampton Roads trying to get a stick on it. That's Jody Frasnick playing it in the corner. They're trying to freeze it in the corner. Frasnick has lost his stick, and he's just kicking it around the board. The Lancers control. Still no score. 13:30 left first period. Lancers shooting at the goal to our right. And with an in-on-goal and a save by Raymond. And the referee, Brett Parsons, calls the play as Raymond fell on the puck right in front of his the goal mount there. Denis Paul with a shot on goal. A nice save that time by Raymond.
Well, Raymond was Johnny on the spot there, Bob. He went down and covered it up. If anything is in around the creased area, the best thing a goaltender can do is get down and smother it and not push it off to the corner, unless that he sees that there's an opportunity for one of his defensemen or forwards to take that puck out of the zone. So they'll generally grab it and smother it.
Here's the face-off to the left of Raymond. And the puck is played around behind the goal, and Raymond has it, and he plays it up to the blue line. Man streaking for the Admirals is Wayne Strip. He takes it to the blue line. Now Gagne going in, trying to get a shot off, but taken off the play by the Lancers is Waver. Puck is pinned in on the boards behind the goal. It's still a loose puck, so no whistle. They're fighting for it. Here are the Admirals going head-to-head. Now the puck is kicked out to the wing, and it's kept in that time by Foy. Here's a shot, that's right, another shot, and a save! Close in front, and now it's cleared out to the blue line. Two excellent chances that time for the Admirals, but Averill was there to make the save. The Admirals controlling at the blue line, dump it in. They'll change lines here and let the Lancers pick it up behind the net. The Lancers and the Admirals, nothing, 12:30 left first period. We'll be joining the World Series at the end of the first period. Rest of the game on tape delay after the Oakland San Francisco game. Here's Foy with a shot. And that is deflected to the far corner. Gagne has it. And his pass behind the goal goes around. Now Foy picks it up. He fires. And that one is wide. Kept in by Taylor. His centering pass is going to be broken up by the Lancers. And a pass to center ice, knocked down by Foy. Well, this kid just joined the hockey club, and he's a go-getter.
Certainly is, Bob.
Now the pass to Gagne at center ice. Gets turned around, but controls, dumps it in, and trying to catch up with the play is McEwen for the Admirals. He takes it behind the goal in a centering pass. taken away by Chickasolo of the Lancers. Now he comes to center ice and on a rush, and here's Corvette going in. Corvette centering pass, shot in, standing on the shot was Chickasolo. The puck comes to the far side and written off the play. Lukey takes his man out of the play. The Lancers still can call a shot in on goal. Ramon's line and can't see it. Now makes the save and covers up.
Ramon did the same thing again, Bob. He went down and cutted that puck. But prior to that, we had a couple of very good chances for the Admirals. McGrath and Black both had great opportunities at the other end. And the score really should be 1-0. They were robbed of a goal there. But Ramon is doing a super job.
Well, he really is. And the defense
got to do a little bit better job of clearing that traffic out from in front of him. Yeah, they certainly do. That's a traffic zone in front there. They just have to keep moving people out of that slot position.
11:29 left in the first period. Nothing. Lancers and Admirals. Hampton Roads trying to clear their own end, and they do. They fire the puck out to center ice, and Steve Herneman is back there for the Lancers. Herneman goes in behind his goal, fires it up, kept in by the Admirals. Shot saved by the defense. Again, it's backed off the boards, and again, the Admirals keep it in, winding up with a strong shot. Hey, it's a hand save. Great, it's shot that time by Krasnick of the Admirals. Now the Lancers moving in on goal, taking solo.
Call on the outside, Don, and it is offside.
I thought he had a pretty good head start.
He certainly did. He was two or three strides in there, and with the crowd noise, you weren't able to hear the whistle, but it was a good call on behalf of the official.
So both teams changing lines here with a stoppage at 10:59.
Again, the Admirals had some great opportunities there. They had two or three shots on goal, and that's the big thing about this game. You have to shoot on the goal. Missing the net or having a blistering shot that's over the net or 3 feet from the target isn't really worth a darn.
Here's the face-off at the center line, and it is going to be controlled by the Lancers, and they will dump it in here. The puck goes behind the Admirals' goal. And coming out of there with it is David Buckley for the Admirals' defense, and he'll play it ahead, and the Admirals putting a rush together. Here's Lukey at the blue line. He goes in. He's ridden off the play, and the Lancer defense is back to get it. And with it there is Herneman. Now the play comes to center ice. The Lancers are in control. Bring it up is Denis Paul. He goes in. Ramon is back there to get it. He fires it around the boards. Kept in by the Lancers. They try a centering pass, and nobody was there. Unable to put a stick out at that time was Nykar of the Lancers. Still, it's another centering pass, and the Lancers are able to keep it in. This one deflected. Here's Nykar. Another centering pass. The Admirals poke it out of there, and the Lancers have to go back to retrieve. We have not had a penalty in this first period. We've played 10 minutes. No score. And here come the Lancers, and it is Nietzsche coming over the blue line, starting to move in on goal. Nietzsche barrels in Ramon with a stick save and pokes it away, and the goal has come dislodged from its mooring there, and time has been called.
Well, Bob, the Admirals are going to have to start clearing the forwards away from the front of that net, and you have to use physical force on it. You have to use the stick. I'm not talking about using the stick as a high stick, but you have to push people away with the stick. You have to push them away with the body. You have to get the stick in between their legs, so when they make a quick move, they're going to fall down. The thing is, you cannot let the people in the front of the net be unprotected, because if they are, a goal is going to go in. And there was a couple of great opportunities there for the Lancers with some shoddy work from the defenseman for the Hampton Roads team.
Now play comes to the near boards. The Admirals keeping it in. The Lancers get a stick on it, and Chelios clears it out of his own zone and through the blue line and going in. Here's the defense knocking it away. This time it is Jordan Foy there to get a stick on it. The puck goes to the far corner on the left side. Now we got a penalty coming up. Delay call. It's going to be against Hampton Roads. The Lancers pull their goalie for an extra skater. And until they lose control of the puck, they will have a man advantage. They pull the goalie here with the delay penalty call against the Admirals. They've got the puck in their own end, trying to set the play up. An empty net staring the Admirals in the face. Now the puck comes to the blue line. The Lancers are still in control. They dump it in, and it goes behind the net. Touched by Ramon and the whistle.
Well, the Lancers had some great opportunities there to get rolling on that delayed penalty. The delayed penalty means they can take their goaltender out and get that sixth attacker. They didn't really do anything with it. They took it down to center ice, and I thought they almost iced the puck in center. There was just no organization, and they should have been able to go back in their own zone.
Judge the Admiral Mike Black, number 9. 2 minutes for holding at 11:18.
Well, the holding penalty, Rob, that was called. So now the power play will be on with the Lancers, and we'll just see exactly what the Admirals have now as far as Kitty Bar the door. 8:42 left, first period, and the heat that they've been putting on at equal strength. Boy, you got to believe this is an inopportune time for that penalty for the Admirals, the way the Lancers have been putting the pressure on Raymond, but boy, he's been equal to it. Now the Lancers shot. Here's a shot and a save by Raymond. A rifling shot by Bob Kelly. Now the Admirals trying to clear it. Can't. Lancers keep it in. And now the Admirals get a stick on it, and shutting it to the far end is Scott Taylor. The Admirals have McEwen, Hood, Lukey, and Greenberg on the ice to try to kill the penalty. 8:10 to play, first period. Here come the Lancers. They go over the blue line. Everybody onside, and again, they are able to poke it away. And Scott Taylor, not once but twice, to do the dirty work.
He certainly did. The power play doesn't seem to be working too well for the Lancers right now, and this is very good defensively for the Admirals. They are they shot the puck down the ice twice, and now they're doing it again.
Now Raymond trying to poke it away, and this time it is going to be for the Admirals' Joey Krasick, and he fires it down to the other end of the ice. 55 seconds left in the penalty to Michael Black. And the Lancers again try the power play, and bringing it up is Chigasola, their big goal scorer from last year. And the Admiral defense knocks it to center ice. And the Lancers will control. And it is going to be picked up at center ice there by Chigasola. He goes in, written off the play by the Admiral defense, the puck to the far corner. And there to get it is Pratt, and he bangs into the boards, down to the point, and to the wing. The Lancers trying to get a shot on goal, but again, the Admirals get a stick on it. They can't clear it this time. 24 seconds left, the penalty, and the Admirals get it out of the zone again. Back to get it is Jeff Waver for the Admirals. He passes to the blue line and is taken by Chigasola. He yields to Richards, who starts to go in. Raymond back to get it, and he flips it off the boards on the near side. 5 seconds left in the penalty, so it looks like the Admirals are going to be able to kill this one off in pretty good fashion. Here's a wind-up and a shot. Raymond makes the glove save. Boy, that was a whistling slap shot from the point by Chilio.
You know, Bob, that was the first shot on goal with the manpower advantage. So the Admirals did a fine job grabbing onto that and keeping people clear there, keeping them away from any shots in the goal. It was just in that last second that one shot came, and it wasn't a tough shot at all. It was something Romance could handle very easily.
6:40 left, opening period. No score. Here it goes. The faceoff is won by Hampton Roads, and Dennis McEwen bringing it up ice. McEwen, 2-on-2, fires in, and this one goes wide. And we've got whistle, and offsides is the call against the Admiral.
That was a close one again, Bob. Offside by probably six or eight inches, but this is a game of inches.
The eagle eye of Pat Shetler, ladies and gentlemen.
There it is. Thank you, Bob.
6:32 left here in the opening period. No score. The draw won by the Lanterns, and they play it to the neutral zone, and it is picked up there by Denis Paul, and he fires it to the wing, and it goes over the glass and into the seats, and souvenir time for the folks sitting down front. And now we got a little pushing and shoving down the eighth for the Admirals and high car for the Lancers. And that got everybody excited.
Well, the Nygaard looks like he's about 7'6". He's a big boy out there, and nothing really happened. They got the sticks up a little bit. I don't know if they'd be penalized at all. There's 6:24 remaining in the first period, and I think the fans have had some good hockey to watch.
Nothing. They're ready for a goal to be scored for the home team. The draw is won by the Lancers. Flanagan rocks his man off the play for the Admirals. Now the puck comes to the wing, and it is batted around the boards and picked up on the near side by Wayne Stripp of the Admirals, trying to clear it to center ice, but unable to do so. The Lancers are able to keep it in, spinning his stock car. I thought they had a height limitation in this league. Man, he's much too big.
Six minutes
to go in the first period. The Admirals are in control. The puck in their own end. Now they lose it. Here's a shot. Broken up by Taylor, just threw his body on the puck to smother that shot. In to keep it is Whitfield for the Lancers. He plays in a centering pass, and this one is knocked out of there by the Admirals and Bobby McGrath.
Admirals just can't seem to clear the zone. Here's a slap shot and knocked down to the defense in front of Alain Raymond. Now the puck comes to the near corner. And a little bit of banging in the boards. And the puck comes free. The Admirals trying to come up with it. But the Lancers again in control. And they go back to regroup and change lines as whistling it into the Admirals zone as Chelios. Now Hampton Roads coming up with the change of lines of their own. Steve Greenberg's line is in there with Lukey and Wasim. So now the Lancers take it, moving in on goal. Here's a shot and a fancy by Raymond. He kicked that shot to his right by Chelios off. Still no score. Now the Lancers control at center ice and dumping it in as Hobson for the Lancers. Here's the puck that bounced in front of the net. Raymond went behind the net to get it, but the defense is there to knock it in. And here's the Lancers dumping it once again. And it is Buckley back to the defense of the Admirals to take care of it there. Now the puck comes to center ice, and here comes Greenberg. Greenberg is over the red line. Greenberg carries it in himself. Greenberg between two defenders. Puck knocked free. Admirals keep it in. Now the Lancers steal the puck, and it comes to center ice. And again, Greenberg is there to poke it back. For the Lancers, it is going to be Doug Hobson, the defenseman there, and he plays it ahead as the Lancers change lines. 4:24 to play in the first period. Here comes Greenberg, a nice drop pass. And with his Lukey, he winds up shooting the thing. And I think we've got an offside call against the Admirals. And Lukey had a shot from the point and really wound up on that one and unable to get it through Steve Averill.
Well, the 18-year-old Greenberg seems to be doing a fine job out there. He skates well. He lagged a little bit on that one. He had a nice drop pass, but he lagged going into the right wing, I think, just because of the strength of the legs, because they haven't had much of a training camp. But he's certainly a fine-looking hockey player out there.
So now, here come the Admirals winning the draw, and the puck is deflected and going back behind the goal to grab it as Averill. There will be a face-off. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey.
This is the Hampton Roads home of the Washington Redskins. AM 79, WTAR, Norfolk.
The draw won by the Admirals. Yeah, the Terry fires is broken up by the defense. Taylor, or Randy Taylor, for the Lancers, and the puck goes flipping into the seats and a stoppage of play. Well, that one went about 10 rows back in the seats at center ice.
Well, you certainly have to watch the puck if you're at a game and it's coming anywhere near you. It's probably harder than a baseball, really, and it's very, it can put a good mark on you, so don't try to grab it, just try to dump it.
The draw, won by the Admirals. They keep it at the blue line. Taylor with it. Went under the stick of Greenberg, and the Lancers now control. Up the near wing, and here's Randy Taylor, the defenseman, taking it down to the blue line, now getting it into the attacking zone, and here's Corvette. And he's taken off the play with a nice body check by Scott Taylor of the Admirals. The puck comes to the wing, and it's shot over there by Jordan Foy, the Admirals, into the length of the ice. Racing after it is Gagne, the goaltender. Is Averill, he's out to get it, and he sweeps it behind the goal and up on the far boards. Picked in by the Admirals. Gagne trying to get a shot and goal. We've got a penalty coming up against Virginia, I do believe. The puck is shot the length of the ice, and the Admirals will control. And the penalty coming up. Pat, you see it?
I didn't see exactly what happened, Bob, but I think the Lancers have a penalty here, and I'm not sure exactly what the situation is.
We'll go down to Bill Bishop as they hit the high stick.
Yeah, the signal is for high stick, number 18.
2 minutes for high sticking. Number 18, Jeff Waver. 16:38. Time of the penalty, 16:38.
Well,
18, Jeff Waver. 2 minutes for high sticking.
Well, the fans are letting everybody know what they think of that particular penalty. Now the Admirals are down again, one man. Power play advantage for the Lancers. They didn't do much with it last time. Still no score with 3:22 remaining in the first period.
The announcement said Waver of Virginia, but it should be 18 of Hampton Roads.
Scott, yes, it is. So it's Taylor that's sitting in the box.
So again, the Lancers will have a power play. And this is their second one of the night, as Pat mentioned. 3:14 left in the first period. Scoreless here at Scope. And the Lancers dump it in. And John Brophy's got his penalty killers out there, led by Dave Buckley, the defenseman. Tried to clear it. He can't. Now, Tripp was frantic. And no whistle.
Yes.
Is there any penalty on that, Bob?
I didn't see Brett Parsons in the corner. He was hiding on the near side. I couldn't see him through the fans, but it is going to be a terrific penalty against Virginia. So the teams will be at equal strength.
Bob Reddy is going to serve that penalty for tripping. The referee picked it up in behind the net, and that took the power play advantage away from the Lancers. So they're playing even strength here now with a one from each. Corbetti just receiving that
Virginia Lancers penalty. 2 minutes for tripping. Number 19, Mike Duvett.
Nothing, nothing. Four skaters aside. 2:49 left, and the
here's a shot out save by Raymond. A left-hander by Denis Paul, and Raymond was there.
Boy, I tell you, Raymond did a super job on that one. He broke right in on Raymond. Raymond had a good glove hand and grabbed onto it, and that saved the day there. He was point-blank range on him. 2:45 remaining here in the first period. No score, Bob.
We'll be joining the World Series in just a moment. As soon as this first period is over, the rest of the hockey game immediately following the baseball and the scoreboard show here on WTAR. The faceoff will be to the left of Alain Raymond, and it is going to be Denis Paul for Virginia. And it's going to be Dennis McEwen in there for the Admirals. 1:24 left in the penalty to Scotty Taylor of Hampton Roads, and 1:48 left in the penalty to Michelle Corvette. Now they get another man in there. Chigasola will take the draw for the Lancers, and he controls it.
In front, backhand, and kicked out of there by Raymond. Boy, he has been outstanding at goal for the Admirals. Lancers have had just a dozen opportunities here. Now the Admirals come to their own blue line. A centering pass, and this one is Murray Hood. Murray Hood with the backhand, trying to go in. Now skates behind the goal, looking for an opening. Now he feeds it back out front, and this is Jody Krasnick, and he lost it off his stick, and it's going to be taken away by the Lancers. And it is going to be Waver. Broken up. Back in a nice feed in the backhand. He could not get the shot off. Boy slams it into the board. Here's a save. And a loose in front of the goal. On the rebound, Mike Chigasolo able to put it in, and the Lancers lead 1-0.
Well, that's going to break the ice a little bit here now. And that was kind of a sloppy goal. It wasn't warranted because the Admirals, Raymond, had two or three fine saves just prior to it. The puck dribbled in behind him when he was out of position. So that's score 1-0 now for that.
Mike Chigasola, number 9, at 17:59. Chigasola from number 8, Dennis Paul.
So 1-0 is the score. The Lancers have it, and still both teams with four skaters aside. 30 seconds left in the black penalty, so the Admirals will have a power play for about 20 seconds. The puck to center ice, and the Lancers are in control. Here's Whitfield with it. He plays it ahead, and the Admirals knock it away. And over the blue line, here's Greenberg winding up, and his pass is, the shot rather, is batted down. The Lancers defense picks it up, and here's Whitfield coming out of there with it. Whitfield over the red line, now his own blue line, and he fires, and it's going to go behind Raymond, picked up by the Admirals, and with it there is Chris Lukey. Lukey spinning, faking, now bring it up. The penalty, the block is over, so the Admirals have a power play for 20 seconds. Taylor, a depth pass, but nobody was there, as Foy now has to go back and defend, is taking it in as Vitale for the Lancers. Admirals with 9 seconds left in the power play. And 1:03 left in the opening period, 1-0 Virginia. Coming up the wing, it is Greenberg. Goes over the blue line, going in, waits, backhand shot, and a save by Averill. And he pushes it off through the right. Now for the Admirals, it is Michael Black. And a shot, here's a save. McEwen with a shot, another save by Averill, and Scotty Taylor back to get it. And the penalty against the Lancers, Corvette, is over. And both teams at 5 aside now. 35 seconds left in the first period. 1-0, Virginia leading. And dumping it in is Bobby McGrath for the Admirals. Less than 1 minute to play in the period. Now, on the near side, with it is McGrath. keeps it alive. Centering pass. Taylor puts a shot on goal. Deflected. Shot saved. Lancers clear. Up to the near boards. And again, the Admirals hit the wide. Hit shot and it's wide. Black really putting some pressure on. Admirals keep it in. And no, it bounces over the blue line. The center ice, Taylor for Hampton Roads. 3 seconds left in the period. 2-1. And that's the first period.
Well, Bob, it was certainly a good first period of hockey. The Lancers have come out of that period with one goal. They both had quite a few shots on goal. Raymond was excellent. He saved the day many times in the early part of the period. And the one that did go in on him was kind of a fluky when they went in behind him. But these things, of course, all count. I think the teams are very equally balanced there. And I don't think that DeBrosi should have any problem making the hockey team out of that, because they're playing against players now that have been playing for 2 or 3 years together in this league and as a unit.
That's the end of the first period of play with the score of the Virginia Lancers 1 and the Hampton Roads Admirals nothing. Now, we will be leaving you at this time, and we will just be catching CBS and their coverage of the World Series sort of on the fly here. And we'll be picking up the action from Candlestick Park in San Francisco. Then as soon as the baseball game is over, we'll be back with the final two periods of tonight's hockey game from SCO. So, for Pat Shetler, this is Bob Rathbun saying so long for the time being. And before we leave you, we can't tell you, Pat, that the shots on goal for the first period, the Lancers had 12 and the Admirals had 13. But it's Virginia with a 1-0 lead. But 13 shots on goal, not a bad number for a young team.
And 13-12 is a very even period, so I think the fans here have got a good period of hockey.
All right. So we'll be leaving you now from Scump and tell you to stay tuned. We've got baseball, and then we have got hockey after the baseball game. So for Pat Sheffield, this is Bob Rathbun for the time being saying so long from Scump. Welcome back to Scope, everybody. Our tape delay coverage of opening night 1989 as the Hampton Roads Admirals face the Virginia Lancers here at Scope. We're at the first period intermission with the score. The Virginia Lancers 1 and the Hampton Roads Admirals nothing. One goal scored on a rebound. The man who led this league in goals scored last year, Mike Chigasola, and he put it past Alain Raymond at the 17:59 mark of the first period, an assist to Denis Paul. And that's the only score we've had to date. 1-0, the Virginia Lancers leading the Hampton Roads Admirals here at Scope. The Lancers had 12 shots on goal. The Admirals had 13 in that first period. And it is a 1-0 score here at the end of one period. We'll be getting some impressions from our color analyst, Pat Shetler, here in just a moment. I'd like to remind everybody that if you can't join us ringside for every minute of this season's East Coast Hockey League action, the Hampton Roads Admirals do have the ticket just for you. Receive a substantial discount off the gate price by purchasing Admirals six-game coupon books. Each coupon is redeemable at the Scope box office for one reserve seat to any home game. Use six coupons for one game or one for six or any combination. Either way, each book is only $30. It's easy to purchase your 1989-90 Admirals coupon books. Call 804-640-1212 to order your Admirals coupon books today. We'll be back with the start of the second period. Comments from Pat Shetler as we continue from Scope right after this 60-second timeout.
Your
Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on AM 79 WTAR is brought to you by U.S. Air. Fly U.S. Air to Florida with flights from Norfolk International Airport. Call your travel consultant today. By Texaco, star of the American Road, a good sign for Virginia. By Home Quarters Warehouse and by Hookos and Leasing. Hi, everybody. This is Bob Rathbun along with Pat Shadler from Scope. Our tape delay coverage of the Admirals opener against the Virginia Lancers just about set to go with period number two. Pat, quickly, your thoughts on that first period of action.
Well, with the 13-12 shots on goal and the one goal difference between the teams, it was certainly well played both ways, defensively and offensively. Milled around the spectators a little bit during the period, and very favorable comments from the people of what they've seen in that first period. Took a drop down to see the referees, asked them what the ice was like and how they thought the game was going. They're friends of mine, these fellas, and they said things were going real well, and they thought the game from their vantage point was excellent also.
Pretty clean first period.
It really was. Really was there. I think there were three penalties altogether and a couple of shorthanded situations of power play for Vinton, but they couldn't materialize on them.
So we're ready to go with period number two. Jeff Waver, Luke Vitale, Greg Nesch, Doug Hobson, Randy Taylor, the starters for the Lancers, McEwen, Hood, Gagne, Buckley, and Taylor for the Admirals. And we are ready with period number two, 1-0 Virginia. Here come the Admirals right off the opening faceoff, moving in on goal, score!
Score 1-1. A beautiful backhand shot caught that top right hand corner. And that's just 7 seconds into the first period. So that's the way to get her started here in the second period. That's certainly a good way to get her started.
And for those Admirals goals, scored at 7 seconds of the second period. Goal scorers number 9, Mike Black.
We will check that goal. I believe it was Wayne Stroop, number 19, but we will check it for you. And now the faceoff.
I think it was 19 that started.
Yes, it was Wayne Stroop that the
19 from Black, I think.
Yes.
But it certainly is a good way to start the second period, as I said, Bob. Yeah, they made the change
Mike
there
Black.
Now.
The Admiral's first goal.
So Black gets the assist. 1-1 tie. 19:27 left in the second period.
Well, that's going to inspire everybody. I see Brophy down there is inspired. The team are, the fans are, and let's get rolling here and see if we can just add a couple more.
Bob. Oh, that got them out of their seats. So the Admirals now have Greenberg, Wasteen, and Lukey on the forward line. And a 1-1 tie here in the second period. Here come the Lancers winning the draw. Randy Taylor, the defenseman, he comes to center ice and he fires it into the attacking zone. It comes on the boards and it's picked out of there by Greenberg. Now the Lancers have to dump it in. Everybody goes back to get on sides and the Admirals will control with Jody Prasnik behind the goal. Prasnik getting it out to the wing and it is picked up there by Chris Lukey. He'll fire from the blue line and that is going to be a chest save made by Averill. Now the play goes behind the net. Here's Lukey trying to get out of a centering pass, and Greenberg couldn't get his stick on the pass, and the Lancers have it. They start a 3-on-2 rush, and here's a shot that goes over the glass and into the end zone, and a stoppage of play and a face-off behind the blue line.
Bob, did you have any indication of what kind of a crowd we have here tonight?
No, I'm just guessing, though, Pat, and I think it's going to be an upwards of 6,000. This building seats 8,800 for hockey, and as you look around, the middle sections are almost completely full.
Oh, yeah, they're full all the way up to the top, so it'd be nice if they have a 6,000 crowd, very similar to the exhibition game that they had here that meant a big thing to hockey here. 18:47 remaining, and this is the second period, the score 1-1.
Making the draw for the Admirals will be Bobby McGrath, and for the Lancers it'll be Michelle Corvette. 1-1, 18:47 left in the second period. And the draw is won by Virginia in the neutral zone, and with it there is Herman, and he's checked into the boards, and the Admirals go back to get the puck, and going back to get it is Buckley. Buckley now losing the puck. Goes back behind the goal to get it, and the Admirals trying to get organized here and move it out of their own end. They had some problems with that in the early going of the first period. Now the pass comes off the stick. It's poked ahead, picked up by Wayne Stroop. The goal score, he winds up, and a stick save made by Averill. He kicks it off to the left side, and the Lancers pick it up, and they start their rush up ice. Coming up in the middle, here is Richards going in on goal, and a save by Raymond. He lost sight of it, but he's got it right between his pads. Well, right out in front of the goal crease.
Well, Bob, the Admirals are getting that puck out of the zone a little better than they were in the early part of the game, and they're taking it right to the Lancers here. And with that goal, that early goal in the second period, of course, it's really going to inspire them, and I think things are going to really get hopping here. The comment from the officials on the ice itself, the ice is excellent. It's fast and non-groovy, so it makes for a good game.
1-1, 18:38 left in the second period. Lancers shooting at Ramon off to our left, and the draw to his left, and it's won by the Lancers, and keeping it in is Whitfield. He tries to shoot, and it's deflected by the defense, and here come the Admirals at center ice. And coming up is Bobby McEwen. He's written off the play hard that time by Dan Richards. The shot goes behind the goal, knocked down on the boards, but the Lancers pick it up. Now the puck comes to the blue line, the neutral zone, and controlling it there is Denis Paul. Going in, winds up, shot and a save by Ramon.
Bob Ramon has a tremendous glove hand. He seems to be, most goaltenders have, but he has an exceptional hand. He seems to be able to just have a good eye and a good hand on that puck. And it's very important because he gets it, he smothers it, and he stops the play when and stops any other action that the Lancers might have or any other ideas the Lancers might have when they're in there.
1-1. Boy, I'm talking to John Brophy, and I said, well, you know, how do you go about building a hockey team? He said, it starts in goal, my friend.
That's right. They've been still around the goaltender, that's for sure.
And boy, the Admirals are blessed with two good ones, Ramon and Kruger. Now the linesman wants to get a couple other gentlemen in there for the faceoff.
Well, they're not facing off properly there, and he did the right job. He just booted them both out, said you watch a couple of guys in that want to face off, and that's all there's to it.
And the Lancers keep it in by Gadan. It's stolen by the Admirals. Here goes down the left wing in a shot goal. Steve Greenfield with the deflection. 2-1, Admirals lead. They got a breakaway, and Chris Hussein stole the puck on the draw at the blue line, and they split it 3-2, and it was Greenberg with the deflection, I do believe.
That's the young man, 18-year-old Greenberg, who I said earlier looks extremely good, number 5, and the fans are going crazy here now, and that puts them 2-1. This is scored within the 2 minutes of the second period. So they score 2-1 now.
Steve Greenberg, assisted by number 7, Chris Lukey.
18:01 remaining in the second period.
Here is the center ice faceoff, and it's controlled by the Admirals. Now they get a quick shot, and this one by Taylor, and it goes wide. And banged into the boards. That time was Krasnick. Now the puck comes into the Admiral zone, and it is going to be the Admirals to control it, and the Lancers getting caught to behind here. The Admirals rushing up the wing, and it's Michael Black going in over the blue line. He'll dump it into the corner, and it is played behind the goal. A trip that time, but keeping his feet was Taylor. He'll play it to the wing, and the Lancers now are able to break out. They've got 2-on-2. The defense is back for the Admirals, and a centering pass is stolen that time by Michael Black. Block coming over the red line. It's going to be 3-on-2. Block going in. Here's a shot, a backhand, and not able to get it off that time was McGrath. And now the play comes out to the point, and it's kept in that time by McEwen. A centering pass, and this one knocked away by the Lancer defense, and it comes out to the blue line, and here comes the Lancers on the attack, and it is going to be Chelios moving in on goal, and he's ridden off the play. Still able to control the puck as he comes up on the near boards. Lancers keep it in. And moving in is Chigasola. He'll fire, and this one deflected way high into the seats in the end zone. And a stoppage of play at 16:39.
Well, the fans are extremely excited here, Bob, and they should be. 2-1 going into the mid part of the second period. They're doing very well. They're coming out of their zone well. They're feeding the pass ahead. And I really think they have the Lancers wondering what's going on.
The Lancers have it behind the goal, and Corvette, he'll bring it up and play it off the boards, and this will deflect up ice and into the Admiral zone, and icing will be the call as it is touched by Fair. So they'll bring it down to the Lancer end, and a face-off to the left of Steve Averill.
Well, I can't say enough for the offensive play of the Admirals. Greenberg, number 5, is the 18-year-old, is just doing a super job out there. Escapes very well, but it's not only him. It's a combined effort of the offensive team. The defense seems to be working well with them too. It seems to be a good combination that's starting to work. And when they can get it working this early in a franchise, we're going to see good things ahead.
16:06 to play, second period, 2-1 is the score. The Admirals have the lead. Goals by Stripp and Greenberg for the home team here in the second period. They get the lead. Here's a shot in front of a save.
Oh,
my! The Admiral's got a shot in front, and Black put it on goal from point blank range. Now we got a penalty coming up on the Admirals.
Well, that was a hook. That was a pretty deliberate hook. Number 20 actually was hurt in the play a bit. Chelios for the Virginia Lancers. It's going to be a, they're calling it high sticking. Number 9 is going to be serving that Black. And Chelios was going down the ice.
Admiral penalty, number 9. 2 minutes for high sticking, Mike Black.
So Black really had to stick around the penalty call it. High sticking.
4:05. 2 minutes for high sticking, number 9, Mike Black.
Either high sticking or hooking, whatever the case is, he's serving two. I think he saved something because Chelios was on his way down the ice there.
So the Lancers will have their third power play of the evening. And now the Admirals penalty killers are out there, led by Grick, and he slaps it into the Lancers end. And now Virginia will bring it up over the blue line. Here is Chelios, and he'll dump it in. Ramon is back there to save it. And Scott Taylor, the defenseman, rifles it out, and it goes the length of the ice. Kicks off the boards, comes to the slot. And Greenberg back there for the Admirals. Boy, he's a real pest. Here's Taylor dumping it in. And they'll kill off a little more of the penalty. A minute 23 left on the penalty to Black. Here are the Lancers now organizing it. Chelios, a power play. Greenberg scores it. He scores!
He got it again. Well, look, that was Greenberg again on a fine job. He put it in that top left-hand corner. And he got the fans extremely excited. This is a fine little hockey player, that fella. He made no mistake at all, Bob, when he got in front of that net. He popped in the top left-hand corner, and the fans, of course, are just going crazy. This is what they need. This is what is needed here.
Admiral score a shorthanded goal at 4:50. Unassisted goal to number 5, Steve Greenberg.
So Greenberg gets the goal. It's his second of the game. And, of course, there's still a minute to go on this penalty to Black. Now the Lancers have it, really, for the first time if they've had anything together in terms of a power play. Here comes the pass to the wing, and a shot. It's kicked, stick saved by Raymond. Lancers are able to keep it in, and it's Paul with it in front. They're looking for a centering pass, and it's deflected and goes to the far corner. Richards there to pick it up for the Lancers. 35 seconds left in the penalty to Black. Lancers setting up the power play now. They have it on the far wing. Pass to the middle at the point, and it's Taylor. He feeds to the wing. They look for a centering pass, some action in front of the goal. They're trying to get the man, Nightcar, out of there. Here's a shot, and it's wide. Powerful shot by Hopps, and the rebound goes to the other end of the ice. Lancers back to get it. Admirals changing on the fly. 3-1. Admirals are leading. 14:05 to play in the second period. Boy, I like this game.
I'll tell you, Bob, it's exciting.
13:55 to play in the second period. Now the Lancers have it. The penalty to Black is over, and they've successfully killed the penalty, and it's going to be the Admirals back to regroup, and the Lancers will change lines after their power play. So a shorthanded goal for Greenberg makes the lead 3-1. And now Stevie has it behind the Admirals goal, and he'll whip it around the boards, and the Lancers are able to keep it in. Pat, is there a tendency to relax after you kill off a penalty successfully?
There really shouldn't be, and that's where teams will run into a problem.
Now the Admirals get it up ice, and they wave off the icing as the goaltender plays up ahead of the goal line, and now Ambrose shooting it to center ice, and it's picked up there by McDuff. McDuff going in on the left wing. Nice body check, but the Lancers are able to keep it alive, and now Hampton Roads taking the puck away, and it's going to be Lukey. Chris Lukey at center ice up the wing, and it comes down to McGrath over to Gagne, and he can't catch up with the play and rifles it off the boards. Now it's picked up at center ice, and the Lancers have a rush. Going in on the right wing. It is McDuff, and he's ridden off the play by the defense. Jordan Foy is there to take it away, and that's going to be icing against the Admirals as they shoot at the length of the ice and is touched by the visitors from Roanoke.
one of the greatest sins, Bob, for a team is to have a manpower advantage and have a goal scored on you. I mean, you shouldn't even be around the other person's net because you should have a power play enough that you can control that puck. When you have that extra man, of course, it's just that there's no way in the world that anyone is going to get that puck from you. But that did happen, and Greenberg got it away, and he showed what can happen, popping in the top left-hand corner. But he was Johnny on the spot. He was there, and he knew where he wanted to put it.
Face-off to the left of Alain Raymond. 3-1, Admirals on top. 12:44 left in the second period. The draw for the Admirals, Murray Hood, and for the Lancers, Luke Vitale. Now they're trying to explain how this faceoff is done. You got to stay outside the circle, boys.
That's right, Bob.
They dropped the puck and Taylor controls for the Admirals behind the goal. Knocked in by the Lancers, and here is just a deflected pass that was batted down toward the goal. Raymond made the stick save. And coming to steal the puck for the Lancers. It comes out to the blue line, and they can't keep it in. Lancers controlling the puck, and now they've got a whistle, and I believe there is some damage to the boards or to the plexiglass over there, and there is a stoppage in play. We'll pause for 30 seconds. You're listening to Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR. 12:37 left in the second period. A 3-1 lead for the Admirals.
We're just trying to find out if we could get the attendance tonight's game. But as we say, Bob, the center area is very packed all the way up. There's some ends that haven't got people on them. But at hockey games, generally, that isn't the place where people filter anyway. So we got a good congregation in the center. And I think it looks like a 6,000 excited group that are watching their team, a new team, 3-1 right now.
And the home team has really put on a show, Pat, here in the second period. A 3-1 lead. They came into the period down 1-0. The boards have been repaired, and the Lancers win the draw. Here is, they got a wave going now here at Scope. Well, everybody's having a big time. Now the Lancers control at center ice. And they dump it in. Scotty Taylor for the defense there to take his man out of the play.
Whoop,
is behind the zone, and we've got a penalty coming up against the Admirals.
Well, the Admirals are going to let the Lancers find out exactly what they can do with that power play again, I guess. We got a pretty good wave going here. The wave is a big baseball. Here we go, right in front of us. It just waved right over us. But the big baseball is looking really good here. They seem to have a good one going.
For tripping.
A wave being when they all jump up and hoot and holler. And that's what they're doing. And they got something to hoot and holler about.
54. 18, Taylor, 2 minutes for tripping.
The Lancers again are going to have that manpower advantage, and if the same thing happens and Greenberg gets a hold of that puck, it might be a disadvantage for them.
Here comes the face-off, and the Admirals whipping around the boards, but the Lancers are able to keep it in, and with it over there is Hobson. The puck bounces right over his stick, and now the Admirals pick it up, and taking it in is Jody Frasnick for Hampton Roads. Picked up by the Lancer defense, and Corvette coming up, comes to center ice, comes to the blue line, goes to the corner, now dumps the pass off, and the Lancers set up the power play. Here's a shot, a save by Raymond. Play goes to the corner. Now the puck deflected behind the net. Picking it up there is Frasnick, and he'll whip it around the boards. And the puck comes out toward the blue line. Lancers can't keep it in. The Admirals pick up the puck and start down the ice. They get to the blue line. Now circling back to center ice. And I'll tell you, Lukey just took the Lancers defender. Here goes in on goal. This one is knocked wide. But the guy that was trying to mark him, he just took his stick and threw it away. Now the Lancers come up ice. And with it there is Corvette on the right wing. Cross ice pass comes to Buster, or rather to Nish. Now back to the right corner. And with it there is Corvette. Circling. 50 seconds left in the penalty to Scott Taylor of the Admirals. 10:55 to go in the second period. Here's a play. Got to move toward the slot, but the Admiral defense is there to jam things up. Now to the point, and a slap shot knocked down from Chelios. 35 seconds left in the penalty. Admiral's defense there to knock the puck away. Here's a center pass, a shot, a save by Raymond, and he falls out at the crease.
Well,
the shot.
Well, Ramon is extremely exciting. He gathered that one into his pads and fell down on it and stopped the play. And really, that was the only opportunity the Lancers had in that power play, and they're still 29 seconds remaining. And they don't seem to have that power play together too well, but the Admirals are certainly doing a fine job in defending it.
10:34 left in the second period, 3-1, the Admirals lead. And both teams changing lines. We'll be home again on Wednesday. Knoxville will be here. 7:30 face-off, our broadcast coverage at 7:15. Here's the draw, and the Admirals knock at the length of the ice. Lancers back to retrieve, and Hobson is with it. And he fires it in, and this is going to be icing called against the Lancers.
Well, the 16 seconds remaining on that penalty, so the power play is going to be with the Lancers again now for the next 16 seconds. They really haven't done too much on their power plays, but they're playing kitty bar the door down at the Admiral's end. They're not allowing a lot of shots on Raymond, but when they do allow them, he's there and able to match anything they have to deliver.
Admirals lead 3-1. And the Lancers win the draw. And the puck is knocked away. Whitfield for the Lancer defense. Having to go back and retrieve it. And now it's Raymond. And he will try to fire it out of there, but that one knocked out. Prastic picks it up for the Admirals. They start up ice. The penalty to Scott Taylor is over, so the teams are at equal strength. And they're going to leave Taylor on the ice. Here's a play now developing in the corner. Gagne goes down in a heap.
That started off with an icing, Bob, and the players went in there, and the linesman might have been a little bit delayed on his arm in the air for that icing, and I think it allowed two players to get in there at each other, and they banged each other around a little bit after the whistle. So I don't know, nothing really has happened here. They're going to take it down the other end, of course, to our left, and the Admiral zone, and it'll be on the icing. The score 3-1 for the Admirals here with 9:57 remaining in the second period.
The Admirals were down one goal to none coming into the period, but Wayne Strip tied it just 7 seconds into the second period. Then Greenberg from Lukey at 18 at 1:59 put the Admirals in front. Then Greenberg on a shorthanded goal 3 minutes later, and the Admirals have a 3-1 lead. So here we go with a faceoff to the right of Alain Raymond. And the faceoff, Greenberg wins the draw for the Admirals, and Taylor has it behind the zone. Now the Lancers have a shot, and a glove save again by Raymond. And Pat Shetler made the excellent point earlier about it. What a great glove hand he has, and it was on display again. Here's Greenberg up the left wing. Greenberg, stick handling. Now a drop pass, deflected. Greenberg goes back to get it. He tries to maneuver around the defense and can't, and the Lancers pick it up and start up ice. Here's Richards coming up the wing, and he's ridden off the play. Now Greenberg going in, barreling in on his man, a centering pass, poked away, and the Lancers trying to keep it in, and slammed into the board. Admirals doing a good job of breaking up, and now Greenberg comes up the right wing. It's Greenberg with a shot, and a save, and the puck is cleared out the center ice, so we've got a fight down in front of the Lancer bench.
We have a play right down in front of the Lancers bench. A couple of the players got into it. We can't exactly see who they are yet.
Boy, one of the Admirals players just getting waylaid under there. And well, a couple of the Admirals want to get in the fight, but the referee won't let them.
Well, they certainly can't get that third man in. Of course, they'll be penalized that way, Bob. So Bob is getting up on the chair now and getting a bird's eye view. And what do we see up there, Bob?
Well, Brophy is about to climb over the boards, and now Buckley for the Admirals is going off the ice, and Herneman for the Lancers. But it was obstructed from our view, Pat, because of the fans here standing in front of us, and the two penalties are coming up, and we'll see what the announcement is.
Well, there were some heavy body checks along the boards in our end there, Bob. They got at each other pretty well, and sometimes you get a good body check like that, and you want to retaliate, and the only way you can retaliate sometimes is pugilism. And I think that's the way these fellows went.
So, I mean, the fans love this. I mean, the fans love the body contact. They don't, people don't have to have pugilism and fighting in a hockey game. A lot of people think they do, but I think the good body checks, the way the two or three were thrown there, it ended up into a little bit of a pugilistic endeavor, but it all started with good, solid body checks.
While we get a break in the action, we'll pause for 30 seconds. This is Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey.
Time of the penalties, 10:45.
9:15 remaining here in the second period. The two Lancers going to be in there. What happened in that particular Malley is a Lancer fellow was checked very heavily, and he didn't like it. And he started to instigate a fight, and of course he got into a fight. He got the 2 minutes for instigating. Then he got a Hermine. He got into it and ended up with that extra 2 minute penalty. They had a little bit of a pugilism. You know one thing, Bob, this is the only game in the world that can be played with pugilistic endeavors. If someone wants to get into a little bit of a fisticuff in basketball or football or whatever it is, they're ejected. But in this game, they go to the sin bin or the penalty box for 5 minutes.
So the Admirals will have 5 skaters. The Lancers will have 4 for the next 4 minutes. Here's a shot and a save by the Admirals. And Gagne keeping it in now for Hampton Roads. The puck in the far corner off the boards. Here's Gagne going out to clear it. Now we've got a pass to the point and a shot, and it's knocked down by the Admirals. And with it there was Murray Hood behind the goal. Now they'll play it across ice. Here's a slap shot, and that lifted off the ice and goes over the goal. And again, the Admirals keep it in. 3-1. Hampton Roads leading. Gagne plays it back out front with it. Prasnik. Jody back to the wing. Back to Prasnik at the point. To the right. Here's this pass knocked down, and the Lancers come out of there with it. 3:20 left in the penalties to Herneman. Now the Lancers go in. And the Admiral defense is there to catch up with the play. Looped by Tally with it on the near wing. Tried a centering pass, but the defense there for the Admirals, Prasnik, breaking it up. Now to center ice, the puck goes over the stick of Gagne, and the Lancers retrieve. 8:15 to play in the second period. The puck goes over the boards, and there will be a faceoff.
It went into the players' bench there of the Virginia Lancers, and one of the players threw it up to one of the spectators, so he has a souvenir. I noticed that the pucks haven't got the logos on them yet. The souvenirs are great when they have logos on. They're just strictly black there now, but I think their pucks will be coming in with the logos. So it's a nice souvenir to get, but when they come up into the stands, make sure you duck. Get the souvenir in your pocket.
Don't try to be a hero.
Exactly. Exactly.
8:16 left. Second period, 3-1. The Admirals are on top. Here's the draw, and it's won by Hampton Roads, and Steve Greenberg has it at center ice. He'll dump it in, and now chase after it. The goalie, Averill, going out to get it for the Lancers. Now Virginia shoots at the length of the puck. They've still got 2:45 left to kill on this penalty. Buckley won out for 5 minutes for fighting for the Admirals. Now Hampton Roads starts the attack, coming up the right wing. Screeching to Aldis Pradnik, tried a centering pass, and that's knocked out by the Lancers, and they shoot at the length of the ice. 7:40 left in the second period, Admirals 3, and the Virginia Lancers 1. Steve Greenberg coming to center ice. Over to Gagne, dumps it in, puts it on goal, and a stick save on a slow shot made by Averill. Now they work it around the near boards, centering pass, nobody there to get it. And the clearing pass knocked down at center ice by Scott Taylor. And we've got the puck going in behind the net now. The Admirals are changing on the fly. And again, it's knocked down. Taylor puts a shot on goal from the point, and it's wide. Now the Lancers have it. And they shoot at the length of the ice, and Raymond is back there to get it for Hampton Roads, and he stick handles it away from a Lancer and plays it on the far boards. And coming up with it now is Chris Lukey for Hampton Roads. He comes to center ice, and this is Murray Hood. Murray with a drop pass over to Gagne. Starts to go in. Still a minute 30 left in the power play for the Admirals. Here's a shot and a save and a rebound. And coming up with it is the Admirals. And with it there is Wasim. Starts to go in. Here's a deflected pass. A shot and a save by Averill.
You know, Bob, we talked about Raymond having good hands. You talk about him having good hands. What about Taylor? I mean, the Taylor, the defenseman there, batted four or five down and just grabbed onto them and kept them in the zone. And that's very important for those fellows to use their hands, too. You just don't have to use a stick in this game. It could be any part of your body. 6:37 left in the second period. Admirals 3 and the Lancers 1. We'll be in Benton, Virginia tomorrow night to bring you the Lancers and the Admirals. 7:15 airtime on WTAR. Sunday we'll be in Johnston. All right, here is the draw, and it is won by the Admirals. They've still got a minute 15 left in this power play. Neither team has been able to produce a power play goal in this game. The Admirals working on the attack. And they keep it in, and with it there is Jordan Foy on a shot in front. Here's moving in, on to a shot, and a great save by Averill. Oh, the Admirals had a great chance that time, but Prasnik just couldn't get it to go past the goalie. Now we got a breakaway coming up for the Lancers, and Vitali going in. The puck is stolen by Foy, and he zoops it out to center ice. And the Admirals have it. Now we have a whistle. And, Pat, I don't know. We may have a penalty against the Lancers here.
I don't think. I think it was an offside. No,
offside. Okay. Well, the referee called it. That's what the...
Right.
Thought he blew his whistle there.
They will. The referee, the odd time, will call it if a linesman does miss something. And maybe it was in behind the linesman that it was called. But there were some great plays there. And number two, Buckley, came back there excellently and took that puck away on the breakaway. He just took it away from the guy as if the guy wanted to give it to him. You know, Buckley's a big boy, and coming around the back of the net and then coming over in the far side close to the blue line, he laid some body in another one. You know, he hit a guy very well, so he took the puck away and hit someone all in within 10 seconds. So that's all part of the game.
6 minutes remaining. Second period, 3-1, the Admirals lead. Three unanswered goals here in the period. 43 seconds left in the penalty to Herneman of the Lancers. And the Admirals will dump it in. And now Chase Afford. And going back there to get it, the Admirals will control. Here is Greenberg with it on the left wing. Circles. Looks for some daylight. Deeks moves in. Centering pass. And it goes beyond Prasnik. And he has to go back and get it for the Admiral defense. So maybe one more shot at it here, Pat. 20 seconds left in the penalty. Prasnik coming up ice, comes to the blue line, and is taken down to play, and no whistle, no penalty. Looks like he was clearly tripped in center ice. Penalty has 5 seconds left, and Ramon is going to zip it out. And it is played there by Craig Lukey, and he gives it over to Steve Greenberg. Greenberg at the blue line, turns to shoot, and that one is batted down by the defense. The penalty to Herneman is over, and the Lancers are back at full strength after killing off 4 minutes of penalty time. Now a deflected puck at center ice. The Lancers will have it. And it is going to be Hobson to dump it in. This one scoots over the boards and it is out of play. And a stoppage here with 4:53 left in the second period.
Oh, another souvenir for the fans there, Bob. 4:53 remaining in this second period. And the Admirals are doing a fine job out there. There was one marginal trip over there. I mean, the referee has two eyes and... sometimes you might be turning the wrong way. I probably would have thought that to be a penalty, maybe a trip, but he didn't, and he's the guy that's controlling it.
Well, get out here and talk to him between periods, shall we?
That's right. We'll have a word with him.
We're going to find a point to the game. Here's the draw, and it's won by the Lancers, and this is going to go back to center ice and now into the Admiral zone, but the Lancers will control, and Denis Paul has it. Paul will circle back, and he plays it now over to Jeff Waver. Waver at the blue line. Bounces the puck off the boards to center ice. The Admirals there to steal it. Taking it away is Prasnik. Now the pass is dumped in, and the Admirals go back and a crunching check on the boards. Prasnik had to take the punishment that time. Back there with Taylor, the two defensemen. Now coming out of there with it is Wayne Stritt, who had a goal earlier in this period for the Admirals. He loses the puck. The Lancers get it back. A centering pass, a shot, and a save by Ramos! A sliding save in front of the goal mouth. And the Admirals hit at the length of the ice. They wave off the icing. 4:10 to play. Second period, 3-1 score. Admirals changing on the fly. The Lancers with a big head of steam. Going in is Waver. He shoots and it's wide. And this one goes to the far wing, picked up by the Admirals and McEwen. He will shoot it down the ice and toward the goal line in the far corner. And Gagne slams his man into the boards. The Admirals pick up the puck, and now we've got an icing call. Against Hampton Roads.
Well, Ramon came up with a couple of excellent saves there. We have a little bit of a pushing match. going on in front of the Lancers' goal. Not really too much. The linesmen are in there very quickly, and the referee has got them quelled. And the faceoff, of course, is going to be down to the left-hand side of Raymond. Getting back to Raymond again, Bob, he's come up with some excellent saves in that period, a couple of point-blank shots. And again, he's very good and very steady and very professional. And I think that's what they need. As you said earlier, Brophy said the team are built around the goaltender. And I haven't seen the other guy in action. You saw him in the second, the latter part of the game in Richmond. But he's doing a super job here tonight. And as the Brophy always says, if they'd like to use the two goaltenders, but if one guy is doing well, they're going to keep him in there until he starts getting rusty. And the way this guy is in there, he's going to be in there for a while.
Yes, sir. Stick with a hot goaltender.
There is a stoppage in play, so we'll take a timeout. We're going to take a 60-second break here at Scope with the score of the Admirals 3 and the Lancers 1. We'll be back in 60 seconds. Welcome back to Scope. 3:40 left here in the second period. Admirals lead it 3-1, and well, they're having all sorts of problems with that plexiglass tonight.
Well, they certainly are. They do a good job. They got it in there very fast, and it's very dangerous if it comes out, and I think they should make these a little more solid on the upright stanchions there to keep these things in, because it could be very dangerous to the players.
Lancers with a shot, and this was wide, and oh, the defense just there to poke it away, as Chigasola nearly had a shot right in the corner after Ramon had gone down, but the Admiral defense was right there, and now they start up ice. The pass is stolen. Admirals, they'll get it back, and they've got a 4-on-2 developing. Here's Gagne over the blue line. Gagne going in. A third pass, and it just went right past the stick of Murray Hood, and the Lancers take over. Boy, they had a great opportunity. Here's a puck stolen, a shot, and a save by Averill. Putting the shot on goal was Dennis McEwen.
Well, number 12, Hood, one cardinal sin in the game of hockey is to not keep your stick on the ice. And it was a beautiful pass over, and he had a stick too high. He had a 6 or 8 inches off the ice, and the puck was a perfect pass on the ice, and it would have been almost a sure goal because they had the goaltender going the wrong way. But you have to keep that stick down on the ice and make contact with it. And Hood knows it himself, and the next time he certainly will have it down there, and he'll be deflecting that puck in the net.
3-1, the Admirals lead, 3:09 left here in the second period. The Admirals win the draw, and the puck sails over to the far corner where the Lancers go over to pick it up. Here's Greenberg putting a body on his man, Greg Nisch. Nisch plays to center ice, and with it there is Whitfield. Whitfield taking it in, poked away by the Admirals, and coming away with it is Chris Lukey at center ice. Lukey up the right wing for the Admirals, dumps it in. Greenberg going back to get it for the Admirals, but now played by the goaltender Averill of Virginia. 2:40 left here in the period. One man goes spinning down, and that's Wasim for the Admirals. Now the Lancers streak to center ice. And going in, it is going to be Waver. He puts a shot on, and Raymond with a skate save. Loose puck. The goal comes off its moorings, and now we have a stoppage in play.
As soon as that goal comes off the mooring, the referee should blow the whistle immediately because the goal can't be scored when it's off, and he could run into a lot of problem because they could be stating was the puck in the air when the net came off or whatever. So his safest thing, as soon as he sees it come off the moorings, is to blow the whistle immediately. He was a little delayed on that one, and I think that he could have probably got it quicker, because if someone tapped that puck in, there could have been a bit of a dispute. But one thing I like about the Admirals tonight, they're back skating. They're coming back, and it takes a lot of legs to come back. It's easy to go offensively when you're going down the ice, but all of a sudden, when you have to come back and get the guy that's going offensively the other way, that's what makes a good hockey player. And these guys are going to be trained by Brophy to do that. And I think after that first period, they were told to do it.
3-1, Admirals lead. Here's the draw. One by the Lancers and a slap shot by Chelios and another shot in front. And that's knocked aside by Raymond. Boy, he has been marvelous in goal tonight. Now the Admirals clear the puck. They get into the neutral zone and start their rush up ice. Here is Hood. Murray going in, puts a shot and centering pass, and this one is knocked aside by the Lancers' defense.
They've certainly not done anything with the Admirals this period. They seem disorganized, but it may not be that they're so disorganized. It may be that the Admirals are getting organized, and I think that's exactly what's happening.
And you know, Pat, this looks like the Admirals, it looks like a new club from one period to the next.
Oh, it certainly does. I mean, the little talking to they had. You know, the big thing is that goal at the 8-second mark of the second period really helps. It inspires them. The second goal inspires them. The third goal really inspires them. And they're going to be hard to beat here in this game.
3-1, the Admirals lead. Here's the draw, and it's won by Virginia. The centering pass goes over the stick of McDuff, and the Admirals will be able to clear it out. Here's the man for the
Admirals Murray Hood going in. A terrific pass with a shot to the high and wide by McEwen. Boy, he was right in on goal. Now Gagne steals it. He walks in. He's going to shoot it. It goes off his stick. They had the goaltender prone, but couldn't lift it up over him. The Admirals have had a couple of quality attempts here, but nothing to show for it. Their lead could be much bigger. The Admirals, here's Greenberg racing back to get the puck. And the Lancers, Randy Taylor beats him to the spot. The pass comes to the blue line. The pass is deflected, and the Admirals will change on the fly here with a minute to play in the second period.
Remaining in the period, 1 minute.
Now the Admirals, here's Gagne going in. Around his skates, tries to push the pass toward goal, but it's knocked aside. And the Lancers zing it out to center ice, caught there by Buckley. Dave will fire it in. The puck is stolen. Now one-on-one. Here's a shot, a fake, and the vet strikes it up. He had a one-on-one, and the defenseman Buckley broke it up. Now it comes to Greenberg on the wing. Stevie going in, the centering pass, and nobody there. Gagne over to get it on the left wing. He will center the pass, and that's knocked down by the Lancers, and they will start up ice 2-on-2. Coming up the far wing, here's Nash going in, a drop pass. In the slot, turning, firing, Chelios, and a goal. Steve Chelios from the point, rifles it home, and it's 3-2.
Well, it got in behind Raymond there, but this happens in the game. There's 21 seconds remaining in the second period. The score now is 3-2, but Taylor has been playing a fantastic game, Bob. A good defenseman.
Chelios.
A good defenseman.
First of the season. Chelios assisted by number 16, Gabby McDuff. Goal scored by number 20, Steve Chelios, assisted by number 16, Gabby McDuff. Time of the goal, 19:39.
Okay, Pat. Gagne is a hockey player that he's small, but he's fast and he's good.
3-2 now. The Admirals lead is cut to one goal. 9 seconds left in the second period. The Lancers coming up the wing, and here's Raymond knocking the shot aside, and that is going to be the end of the second period. So the Admirals go to their locker room, 3-2, and Pat, you talk about momentum, and I wonder what that last goal will do for Virginia, because they've got to feel better about themselves after that goal.
Oh, they certainly do. When you're two goals down in a 3-1 game, and all of a sudden you score a goal at the latter part of the period, and you go in the dressing room with some fire in you, and just being one goal down, they're going to come out with some fire. The same as I think the Admirals came out at the start of the second period when they scored that goal. One hockey player that, Bob, that I was that I'm very impressed with out there is number 6, Gagne, for the Admirals. He's a French-Canadian guy. He's small. He's very maneuverable on his skates and a great playmaker. And one other player that very much interests me out there is Taylor, the defenseman. He's made two or three fine plays and saves on the defense prior to that goal being scored. And I think he was on a player change when that was being done.
Okay, here's the restart, and it comes in 3-2. Good job, everybody. We are between periods with the score, the Admirals 3 and the Virginia Lancers 2. 4 goals scored in that period, 3 by the Admirals. Wayne Stripp tied it with a goal assisted by Mike Black, with just 7 seconds expired in the period. That made it 1-1. Steve Greenberg then had the go-ahead goal at the 1:59 mark, an assist from Lukey. That made it 2-1. Then Greenberg, when the Admirals were shorthanded, stole a pass, walked in on goal, and fired one past the Lancer goaltender, Steve Averill, and that made it 3-1. And it stayed that way until the 19:39 mark of the second period, when Steve Chelios went in and scored on assist, or rather from McDuff, and that made it a 3-2 game here at the end of two periods. Pat, your comments on period number 2.
Well, I thought the Admirals played a much different type of hockey game than they did in the first period. It looked like a different team altogether out there, Bob. They came out with fire in their eyes. They scored at the 8-second mark. They went ahead 3-1. Had a little bit of a downfall in the latter part of that period where they Virginia got back into the game, and now the score being 3-2. I think Virginia are going to go into that dressing room with a little bit of a fire and saying we can come out and get these guys. But the Admirals have played super. They have They've done very well defensively. Taylor has done well. Greenberg, I'm very, very amazed with him. And there's a lot of other hockey players that are not maybe as startling out there now, but they're going to become that way. And I'm saying it doesn't take everybody to, everybody doesn't have to be a Bobby Hull or a Wayne Gretzky. I mean, you need the other people along with them to do the job. You just don't have a bunch of Wayne Gretzky. But I think that this Greenberg, Gagne, Lukey, McGrath, I think that these guys are a fine group, and back on the defense there, the Taylor, I just can't get over Taylor, and Stripp, he had a couple of good shots and goal, he scored a goal that period, and I think he's super also. I think the Lancers are really starting to feel that the Admirals are a hockey team right now.
Yeah, I think that's right. I felt, Pat, that Virginia controlled that first period. You know, they just seemed to be a little more on their game. The Admirals trying to get their feet wet, excited about playing in front of a big crowd, no doubt, wanting to do well. The lines were getting organized, guys playing together for the first time, and I thought Virginia controlled that period, but boom, Wayne Stripp scored that goal 7 seconds into the period, and it just, everyone came out of their seats and just raised the intensity level, and I thought the Admirals just took off from there.
Right. You know, good fans, Bob, are worth a goal or two a game, and the fans here are great. I think fans are always great if a team are winning, and it's very important, even if the team have a bit of a slump, to support them with cheers and hollers and not get down on them, and this will happen. I mean, the Admirals, I have a feeling, are going to win this game tonight. They're playing as they should if they played the way they did in the second period, but they're going to have their downfalls the same as anybody is, and I think you got to get with the spirit on it, and I love the wave they had here. I love enthusiasm of fans. In Boston, for example, when we officiated games in Boston, you had adrenaline in you as soon as you skated out on the ice. Now, we did as officials, the players did, I'm sure, the same way. And it meant a goal or two to the Boston Bruins. Then you go into places like Toronto, and Toronto are a very subdued, sit-on-the-hands type of crowd. They're very rambunctious and boisterous when their team are winning. But when their team are down, they want to blame everybody. They want to blame the coach. They want to blame this. They want to blame the centers. But that isn't the way to do it. You know, and the way the fans are doing here tonight is just excellent. They're enjoying it. They're all eating their hot dogs, and they're talking it up. And I think when they leave here and get onto their places of business tomorrow, where they're going to be saying, by golly, you really missed something there last night. And I think that it's going to be inspiring to the players, inspiring to the management to really make something big and good of this.
Okay. When we continue, we're going to talk with Blake Cullen here for just a minute. It's 3-2, the Admirals lead. We're in the second period intermission, and we'll continue from Scope after the 60-second timeout. And a reminder that the Admirals will be donating $10 for each goal that is scored this year. So, and that goes to the Special Olympics. So the Admirals tonight have put $30 into the till on goals by Wayne Stripp and two by Steve Greenberg, and we'll be keeping that total going all season long to just indicate that the Admirals want to be a part of this community, want to give something back to the community, and they will do it by contributing money on each Admiral goal this year. So the Admirals have put $30 into the till so far. Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on AM 79 WTAR is brought to you in part by U.S. Air. Fly U.S. Air to California with flights from Norfolk International Airport. Call your travel consultant today. By Home Quarters Warehouse, Picosa Leasing, the leasing professionals, and by Texaco, you can trust your car to the man who wears the star. The Admirals and the Lancers back on the ice. We'll be back with the third period in 60 seconds.
Yeah, the greatest fire in their eyes could be the end victor in this particular game tonight. But with the Admirals ahead by one goal, 3-2, they certainly have the upper advantage. Fans are very excitable here. They're hooting, they're hollering, and they're enjoying. And that's one of the big things.
All right, here we go. The third period. Stripp, McGrath, and Black, the forward wall for the Admirals. And the opening faceoff goes into the Hampton Roads zone. The Lancers have it there, and it's going to be rolling in front of the crease and knocked away that time. And coming out of there with it is Jordan Foy for the Admirals. And he'll play it up the ice now to Bobby McGrath, and McGrath will dump it in and put a shot on goal, and it is saved there by Averill. Now the pass comes to the far wing, and the Lancers are able to clear it, and streaking down the ice to try to catch up with it is Dan Richards. Back behind the goal is the Admirals' man between the pipes, Alain Raymond. And we're going to have a stoppage of play and a face-off to the left of Raymond.
I don't think number 30, Bob, Avril, in the goal for the Lancers seems too steady to me. He just doesn't seem to be steady in his feet, and he doesn't seem to be cutting off the angles. One good thing about a goaltender is just to cut off the angles so the forward, when he's coming in, doesn't see any twine or doesn't see any net, and he doesn't seem to be doing it. Maybe because he's a smaller fellow, I don't know. But there were a couple of small ones. Gump Worsley was about 5'3", one of the best in the world, so I guess size has nothing to do with it.
Can't measure the size of the heart, though, sometimes.
That's right, exactly.
All right, here's the face-off, and the draw has been won by the Admirals. And coming out of there with it is Chris Lukey, and he will flip it up the ice. Back there to get it is Bill Whitfield for the Lancers, their defenseman. And here is the Admirals' Chris Racine taking a man off the play, and now the puck is frozen in the far corner. 18:58 left in the game. 3-2. Hampton Roads is leading. Don't forget, after our game, stay tuned for the Texaco Star of the Game show. And we'll also be trying to get some comments from John Brophy. We're going to send Pat Shetler down with our wireless microphone here and go right down by the Admiral's dressing room to talk to John and the Star of the Game when this one's over. So here we go. The faceoff is won by the Lancers. And they whip it around the boards, and it's going to be picked up at the blue line, and the Admirals steal the puck. And with it there is Westin. He'll put it in front. No one there. A center pass almost off the stick of McEwen, but now the Lancers are able to take it and broken up at center ice. And here's an offside call against the Lancers. Is going in was Chigasolo, who has a goal in this game.
Well, the Lancers don't seem to be having much drive here in the early part of this period. And the Admirals seem to come out here with the same fire and enthusiasm they did in the second period. And very short time into this period, so we got a long way to go yet, Bob.
Here's the faceoff at the spot outside the blue line, and it is going to be kept in by the Lancers. And back there at the defense is Jordan Foy for the Admirals. He'll play it ahead now to Murray Hood. Murray dumps it in on the right side to Gagne. Kept in, and a quick shot on goal, broken up by the defense. And now the Admirals must retreat. The Lancers control the puck. Center ice is breaking in. Here goes Chigasolo, and he can't get the shot off. Fanning on that one. That time was Corvette, and the Admirals play it up the ice. Krasnick taking it in behind the goal. Puck knocked free. Now it is a shot, and that one is wide by Krasnick. And this one comes out. Taylor unable to keep it in. Scotty going back to center ice, and he plays it back there to Joey Krasnick. Krasnick will dump it in, and Averill, the goaltender, back there to stop it. Now the pass is whipped around the boards, and the Lancers trying to get it out. It's a 3-2 lead for Hampton Roads, 17:45 to play in the third, and here it goes. Man streaking in on goal, and that is Chigasolo, and he's ridden off the play, and now we've got a frozen puck in the corner.
That Cavretti, number 19 with the Lancers, came through there real well. He skates well. He had a lot of power. He went right through the two defensemen, but he didn't get anywhere behind the net. So the face-off now will be to the left-hand side of Raymond in the Admiral's zone.
17:37 is the time remaining. And the face-off won by Hampton Roads. And the Admirals will get it up ice, and with it there, it is going to be broken up by the Lancers, and they'll send it back into the Admiral zone. Taylor, the defenseman, there to play it, and he peels out to the wing. He gets it over now to McEwen, coming up the left wing, and the puck is, and a penalty coming up on the Lancers. Admiral still in control of the puck, and it goes behind the Lancer goal. And now play is stopped and holding.
We got a holding penalty there, Bob.
And so, it's the Lancers.
So here's a good opportunity for the Admirals to show what their power play will do. And they really haven't had, I don't know, have they had one during the, I think they were pretty even there.
They had number six, Doug Hobson. 2 minutes.
Now that's number six.
Holding.
Hobson has a holding penalty.
59.
And the faceoff will be down in the
time of the penalty.
In the Virginia
49, correct.
17:11 remaining in the second, in the third and final period.
They've had one power play advantage for about 20 seconds.
Yes, very short.
Back in that first period, that has been all. Okay, right. Now the Admirals have it. And going in over the blue line, here's Gagne on the left wing. He plays it back out to the point, and a shot, and it is just wide. And this one is going to be in
on the back of the mesh.
Back of the net there, and play is stopped. And point blank that time, from the point, that Jordan Coy had a pretty good shot. He's a left-hander, and he really fired that one, and it just went wide. 3-2 Admiral, 16:53 left in the third, and 1:43 left in the penalty to Hobson. Taking the draw, Murray Hood for Hampton Roads. Face off to the right of Avery. So we're ready for the draw. Here it is. And the draw is won by the Admirals. And they're able to keep it in. And here's a quick shot and smothered on his knees. Steve Averill, the Admirals, Lancers goaltender. McEwen was able to put a shot. It was a backhand in the weak attempt, but he was able to get a shot on goal. And 1:36 left in the Admirals power play.
You know, the power play is such an important thing, Bob, and I know Brophy will have his system down here very shortly. They shouldn't let the other team even touch the puck in that 2 minutes. I mean, if your power play is working properly.
Lancers trying to clear the zone, but keeping it in is Foy. Now the Lancers are able to poke it away from Foy and back there to get a Jody Prasnik for the Hampton Roads Admirals. Now they come up ice, and here's Foy playing it into the attacking zone. Gagne can't control it. It's on the wing, and they fire it out to the Lancers and the length of the ice, and Ramon is back there to stop it. And going back to get it, Prasnik for the Admirals. They'll start up ice. 1 minute left in the penalty. Now, coming in, here is Gagne. Here's a shot. Penalty coming up against the Lancers, and it's going to be a high stick against Jeff Waver, and this is going to give the Admirals a two-man advantage for the next 54 seconds.
Well, this is really going to tell the power play, and the Lancers should never touch the puck in this one. They're playing five skaters to three, so it's a great advantage with 16:05.
Called at 3:55. Number 18, Jeff Waver, doing it for ice-sticking. Ice-sticking penalty on Jeff Waver, number 18 of the Virginia Lancers. Top penalty, 3:55.
Well, it's one of the greatest opportunities, Bob, in any hockey game, and that's to have five skaters against three. And the Lancers have 2 men in the penalty box, 1:54 seconds remaining, and of course this full 2 minute penalty for the second one. So now they're going to really put on the power play, and the Lancers shouldn't touch the puck, and the next time we should see it, it might be in behind the net.
Back of the net, my boy, that's a good place for it.
Back of the mesh, me man.
Yes, sir. 16:05 to go, and now the Admirals start the 5-on-3 advantage, and here comes a shot on goal! Jody Prasnik! Admirals lead 4-2!
Well, that was a great shot from the point, and that's exactly what has to happen on a power play, and that's exactly what has to happen. They put the puck in the net, and it's exactly what we said. There's going to be still a man short for the Virginia Lancers for the next 1:55. So one man can go to the penalty box on that goal. So now the score is 4-2, and that's a nice jump and a nice lead here right now, Bob.
Play goal scored by Jody Prasnik, number 4, assisted by number 2, Jordan Coy, and number 7, Chris Lukey. Time of the goal, 4:01.
So now the face-off, and the Admirals still with a man advantage here, and a centering pass to the point. Prasnik winds up again, and this one just trickles wide of the goal on the right side. Gagne with a shot and a pad save at his knees by Averill. And the Lancers now control at center ice. The Lancers start to take it in, poked away by the Admiral defense. And the Lancers have it again at center ice. 15:25 left in the third period. 4-2, the Admirals lead. Here's Jordan Foy coming up, playing it up the wing, and it goes to Murray Hood. Back to Foy. Foy dumps it in. Rebound behind the goal. And we've got a nice check into the boards. A loose puck in front. And the Admirals able to keep it in. Here's a shot and a save by Averill. Nice backhanded attempt by Jordan Foy from the point. but the Lancers control it. They bring it out to center ice, and clearing it there is Don Richards. Richards taking it in. Lancers are going to change on the fly here, and the Admirals are coming up ice. And their catch, they caught the Lancers in a line change that time, but they could not take advantage. Puck poked away, and Ramon controls it behind the Admirals' net. Now the Admirals here, Stevie Greenberg going in. Stevie on the left wing. Stevie barrels in, shoots, and scores! A hat trick on opening night for Steve Greenberg!
By number five, Steve Greenberg, unassisted. That is his third goal tonight. Gives him the first hat trick of the season. Number five, Steve Greenberg.
So back to the action now. The Lancers have the draw, and it comes up to center ice. And with it, there is Whitfield. And the puck hand, we've got some banging going on here in front of the Admirals. We've got an elbow penalty, I believe, called here against the Admirals, and this is going to be on Bobby McGrath.
Yeah, we have a couple of penalties there, Bob, that we'll have to sort out. The referees are still trying to sort this out. Number 13, Richards, and 14, McEwen are looking at each other with kind of cross eyes.
There's the announcement. Number 8, Bobby McGrath. 2 minutes for elbowing at 5:43. 2 minutes for elbowing. Number 8, Bobby McGrath.
So now the shorthanded situation for
once
the Admiral. You remember they were in the lead this game 5-2 with 14-17 remaining here in the third final period. They certainly have control. They come out here in this third period the same way. But I'm so impressed with Greenberg.
He is a dynamo.
Oh, he really is. I mean, he's got a good shot. And what I said earlier, he's a back checker, and that's the big thing. He skates back. A person that Brophy will love.
Here's the faceoff, and it's won by the Lancers, and they will regroup now and start their power play. 5-2. The Admirals are on top with 14:05 remaining. And the Lancers will fire it in, and it goes whistling all the way around the boards. Picked up by defenseman Jody Frasnick of the Admirals. And he plays at the length of the ice, helping to kill this penalty. And it is going to be shot in by the Lancers, and Ramon is there to scoop it up. And he'll hold onto the puck to stop play and draw a faceoff with 13:41 left.
Well, I don't know if Averill, the goaltender for the Virginia Lancers, is weak, as I thought he might have been in the latter part of the second period, but really it's not all the goaltender. I mean, it's the offensive push that the Admirals are putting on, and maybe the little defensive weaknesses and as far as the Lancers go, but certainly the Admirals are well deserving of this 5-2 lead right now.
Lancers on the power play. They're moving around after the faceoff, and Frasnick able to knock this one away, and the Lancers have to regroup just a bit. Admiral's doing a good job setting up this box defensively to kill this power play, and the puck goes over the stick of a Lancer, and it's rifled around the boards by Ramon, the Admiral's goaltender. A minute 5 left in the penalty. Here's a shot and a great save by Ramon on the rebound. They put it in, and it's going to be Tigasolo, and Tigasolo had something to say to Jason Foy after he scored the goal, and Foy and the goal scorer, Tigasolo, are in a wrestling match in the faceoff circle on the offside. And Tigasolo is being handled pretty well by the Admirals defenseman. Now the linesmen go in to break it up. But you know, it was interesting, Pat, that Tigasolo on a rebound. Tigasolo
almost scored the goal. Ned Turnerout had something to say.
I don't know what he could have said, but he got a bit of a licking, I think, from number two, Foyes. He went after him pretty well. The linesman let them grab onto each other and enter into a little bit of a dancing match for a period of time, just to see if they wanted to get out of their system. So there's going to be one in their reach. I don't know what he could have said after the goal. I mean, after a goal, you say hooray. I don't think you have anything else. Hooray, I scored. Well, maybe Boyes didn't like the way he said it or something. I don't know, but they're going to be sitting in there. I don't know whether they'll only have maybe a two-minute roughing penalties rather than fighting. They didn't really get into any pugilistic endeavor there. But the referees are over in the referee streets. You notice, Bob, that the linesman let them fight there a little bit, or let them grab on, let them get it out of their systems. And a lot of times the lines will get in there too quick and try to break it.
Boy, Chickasolo, he doesn't like
Chickasolo is waving his stick up at the fans, actually, which isn't a good thing. It's very, very bush league. He's got a game of conduct at the bush league, and so he's going to be ejected from the game. Going to be getting away there. Chickasolo scored the goal. He started a fight after he scored the goal, and then he goes over to the penalty box and he decides that he's going to say a few things to the fans. And the referee, of course, didn't like that, and he's going to get rid of him. So he's gone to the dressing room for a game misconduct.
Boy, that doesn't hurt at all, Pat. He scored two of the Lancers' three goals.
He's a bit of a hothead. I can tell as the game went on. And you don't need hockey players like this in your team because it's to a disadvantage. Because what's happening now, his line also has a problem because he's not on there. So their coach is going to have to interchange his line to take up for the loss of this player. But, I mean, he scored the goal. I mean, I don't know why you have to get into anything like this. But I'll tell you one thing. The fans love it. And the fans loved it when he was being ejected and taken off the ice. He didn't like it too much, but that's all.
The Lancers credited to number 9, Mike Chickasolo. Assistant guy number 12, Luke McNally. And number 19, Mike Bouvet. At 6:46, third goal for Lancers. 13:45,
I was hoping, Pat, that we might be able to get the penalty announcement as well, but I think it was a game misconduct, Bob, but we'll check that here.
I thought maybe before we get a penalty, but apparently not. So here we go with the Lancers controlling center ice after the face-off. They will dump it in here. The teams are at equal strength. The
Admirals' defense will now change. So first skaters on the ice for John Brophy. Here are the Lancers. And a nice check from behind, but the Lancers still control it. Here is McDuff going in, and we've got an offside against the Lancers. 12:11 to go in the third period. 5-3, Hampton Roads.
Well, there seems to be a lot of body contact out here in the latter part of this third period, which is something people like. You'll sometimes get a lot more body contact, Bob, in a situation where the players are a little more tired. The fatigue is setting in a little bit because they haven't had that long a training camp. But that gets into some body checks, and sometimes that can create some injuries because of the situation of not being in the same shape.
Fight here between 14 and 19. Nykar for Virginia and Wayne Stripp for the Admirals, and Stripp's on his back and Nykar's on top of him, and as big as Nykar is, this could be very...
That was an instantaneous fight. It was right after the drop of the puck, and they just went at each other. They had a few things to say, I think, and they planned as soon as the puck was dropped to go at each other, and they're doing quite a bit of wrestling on the ground here right now. We have number 14, Nygaard. and number 19, Stripp.
And I think they're going to throw Nygaard out of the game. I think they've thrown Nygaard out.
I would say they probably should throw them both out.
with this little time left in the game, it's a good thing to get rid of the folks, and it saves a lot of problems. There's number 14, Nygaard, leaving the game.
Unless
they're going to have company in there.
They should give Chickasaw a little company in the locker room.
They need company in that locker room. But I tell you, they have to do a little something different. They're behind the game by two goals right now, and pugilism isn't going to bring them back to in the game at all. So with 12 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the third period, the score 5-3 for the hometown Admirals. The referees are over there trying to sort a some penalties. There have been two players ejected so far.
The Admiral, number 19, Wayne Stritt. 5 minutes for fighting each.
Now remember, as we said,
for Barry Knighton, number 14 of the Lancers, and Wayne Stritt, number 19 of the Admiral. Also, a 10-minute misconduct for Barry Knighton of the Lancers.
Okay, Ben. Well, they're still trying to sort these penalties out. As we said there earlier in the intermission, in the first and second period, that this is the only game that you can probably indulge yourself in some pugilism and just get penalties. You don't like to get too much of this. These are kind of wrestling matches, but what really happens and why they get into it, I think, is because they're tired. They're a little tired now, and instead of skating, it's better to grab onto someone and to have a little dance. We always used to call it dancing and not fighting a lot of times.
There's the draw, and it's won by the Lancers. 12 minutes to go in the third period. 5-3 is the score, with the Admirals leading the Virginia Lancers here on opening night. And we've got the play in the near corner, kept in by the Lancers, and now the puck could pop the blue line, and everybody's offside, so they'll have a faceoff.
So the faceoff now is going to be to the right of Raymond, and Raymond is... it's been very, very steady in goal. Very good to the glove hand and grabbing on anything that was loose around the net. And the fans here, Bob, are excited because they're seeing a hockey team that are going out there and really trying to play hard and well.
And the opening draw. And here it is, one at the center ice for the Lancers. They play it in, and back there to get it is Jerry Prasnick for the Admirals. And he brings it up now to Chris Lukey. Lukey dumping it in, and back behind the goal to get it is Averill, the Lancers goaltender. Now the puck comes behind the net, and it is taken away this time by McDuff. McDuff heading up ice, goes to the center, now up the left wing, and the Admirals knock it away, and the puck's at the red line, and there is a nice play by Wasine to knock the puck away. Goes into the attacking zone, and coming up with it is going to be Gabby McDuff for the Lancers. McDuff at his own blue line. Now passes ahead to center ice, and it is Denny Paul. Paul going in, and he's ridden off the puck, and it is Raymond to go back there and get it, and Taylor doing a good job of defense that time for the Admirals. You really like him, Pat.
Certainly do.
That's 55 to go in the game. 5-3, the Admirals lead, and circling is defenses Buckley. Buckley to the blue line, and the puck comes free, picked away by Whitfield. Whitfield now playing it back behind the Lancer goal. 10:40 left to play in the game. Here's a loose puck, and the Lancers in their own end having a little trouble clearing, but now they get ahead of steam, and coming up is Steve Chelios. Chelios over the blue line. Chelios going in with a backhand, shoots. Raymond with a save. Loose in front, and Raymond covers up.
Well, Raymond didn't see it there first, Bob, and then all of a sudden he came loose, and he's got cat eyes. I mean, he just went right after that puck and smothered it, because if he didn't see it and it took a funny bounce, it certainly could have dribbled down into the net. They can't afford another goal now. With 5-3 is a nice lead. 5-4 makes it too close.
10:31 to play in the game. Third period from scope, 5-3, the Admirals lead in what has been a most exciting night of hockey here. Don't forget, we'll be in Vinton for the rematch tomorrow night. We'll be on the air at 7:15. 5-3, the Admirals are on top. Here's the draw in the Admirals zone to the right of Raymond, and it is won by Hampton Roads. And clearing it out this time is going to be Gagne. Now,
loose in front.
Oh, my.
Evil save.
close, too close for comfort. Now the Admirals, Raymond goes back to stop the puck behind his own goal, and defenseman Jody Prasnik will take it out of there. Prasnik goes down to the ice, but zips it out. Now Greenberg coming to the blue line. Greenberg fighting for the puck and sends his man into the boards. Now we've got the puck coming free, and it is going to go back toward goal and stopped by Averill. And the Lancers put up the boards. Now Greenberg steals the puck. He gets it over. Shot to save. Loose behind the puck. And a great shot by McEwen. Now straight in. Shot by Flanagan, though. And it goes wide. And this one ends up on the far boards. And the Lancers take care of it. And a loose puck at center ice as McEwen knocks his man off the puck and then retrieves. Flanagan shoots it in for the Admirals. 9:25 to play in the third period. And the Admirals changing on the fly. We got a little fisticuff right in front of the Hampton Roads bench. It is going to be Wasine for the Admirals and Niche for the Lancers. And they're really plugging out. Tie it through. Both though with left hands. Now they're going to swing a little more. Boy, that one, Pat, came as they were changing on the fly, and was seen in Niche. Had a few words, then the pushing started, then the blows were exchanged.
They really got some good blows, and there was no dancing, as we talked about earlier. They're, matter of fact, they're still punching each other. The linesmen finally have got them broken up, Bob, and they're going to be heading to their respective penalty benches. Number 15, Wiesen. Got some pretty good licks in there, actually. They're both big boys. Number 17, Niece for the Lancers. They ran into a bit of a shoving match and a bumping situation right in front of the benches down in front of us, and they decided that they would just get into some of the swinging. The linesman did let them go, and so they're going to be serving a little bit. So I think that the fans, Bob, have a little bit of everything to see tonight. A lot of goal scoring, good goaltending, a few little pugilistic endeavors.
Yes, sir. I like how you call those. Pugilistic endeavors.
But anyway, they have 5 minutes to think it over there.
Hey, don't you want to go up to Vint tomorrow night for the rematch? You think they're going to be waiting for us tomorrow night?
Certainly will they. It'll be a good one there tomorrow night. We're going to tune in for sure, Bob.
And number 15 in the Admiral, Chris Wheaton.
So 2 5-minute majors, and then there's going to be a Niche and Wasine of the Admirals.
Well, they got their 5 minutes worth.
That they did. That they did. So 9:22 left. There's a break in the action. We're going to pause for 30 seconds. You're listening to Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR. Scope, everybody. 5-3 is the score. The Admirals lead the Virginia Lancers with 9:22 remaining. And here is the face-off, and it's won by the Lancers. And going to center ice to get it is Waver, and he starts to dump it in. Raymond back there to stop it for the Admirals. And the Admirals start to play it out. And now the puck is taken away, and the Admirals are in control. Here's McEwen coming up the left wing, and he will dump it in. And the Admirals play getting a little more physical here. And the puck goes into the boards, and they scrap for it. Gagne's in there for the Admirals. Puck comes free in front of the Lancer goal, but it is Chelios to take care of it there for the Lancers. He plays the blue line, and Chelios is offside as he went in ahead of the play. Waver was controlling the puck.
As you said, Bob, the action is getting a little more robust now. The 5-3 makes quite a difference in the score. And the team that are down at the 3, which Vinton are wanting to get a little more physical, really, than the Admirals. The Admirals are satisfied just to keep it the way it is at 5-3. But there are some good body checks out here tonight. There's been a little bit of everything, which is nice.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
For opening night.
For opening night. Excellent.
8:46 to play. Third period. 5-3. Admirals on top. And we're waiting for a face-off here. And the face-off comes at the spot outside the blue line. It's won by the Admirals. And Jody Prasnik stick handling at center ice, comes to the red line and dumps it in, and Steve Greenberg is back there to get it, slams his man into the boards. Puck is picked up that time by McGrath, and now the Lancers pick it off, and they come up ice the other way. At center ice, a 3-on-2 rush and a centering pass, and it goes beyond his man. Good defense that time by the Admirals to break that play up. Scotty Taylor doing the deed there defensively, and here's the puck in front of the net, and Raymond falls on it, and now plays it over to Jody Prasnik. 8:13 left to play in the third period. 5-3, the Admirals lead it. Hampton Roads controlling in their own zone, and it is going to be Prasnik behind the goal, fiddling and diddling back there, and never did clear the puck. And here's Raymond falling on it.
Was backwards.
Boy, he didn't know what was coming at him that time. That puck just sort of danced across the goal. He tried to find it, and he looked like he was trying to do a handstand.
Yeah, he really did. He looked like he was trying to crawl back into the net. That's the first time I ever seen a goaltender's other end on the outside. But the thing is, he did the job. I mean, he grabbed on the puck, and again, he doesn't let that puck loosely around the goal. He grabs on, and that's very important. So now the face-off to the right-hand side, and with a save that he made there that could have closed that gap a little closer.
5-3, Admirals lead, 7:58 is the time remaining. Third period from SCO. Here's the play, and the draw is won by Hampton Roads, and they scooted around the boards, and the puck rolls all the way out to center ice. Gagne going in to try to get it, but the Lancers will control, and back there to get it, it is going to be Jeff Waver, and he plays to center ice, and a nice pass comes up to Dan Richards. He drops it, and a shot, a fake on a shot from the blue line by Waver. He starts to take it in, and that one's knocked away, and the puck goes rifling into the lower box seats.
Well, you know, Bob, this game is extremely fast. The hockey players are moving anywhere between 20 and 30 miles an hour out there. The puck, when it's shot on a slap shot, is moving somewhat 60, 70, 80 miles an hour. So it's a fast game, and anybody that's home listening to the broadcast tonight that haven't seen a game, by all means, come out. Women love the game, too, Bob. They just seem to, they'll bring the husbands out. You know, get some of the couch potatoes, couch potatoes away, and Mama will say, let's get out to that hockey game.
Yeah,
the Admirals on.
I'll vote for that. 7:30 left to go in the game. 5-3, the Admirals lead, and a face-off at the top of the circle to the right of Raymond, and the Admirals win the draw. And back on it defensively is David Buckley, and he plays it around the boards, and it comes up to the near boards where it is taken care of by Murray Hood. Now the Admirals have a break going, and they play it up ahead, and with it is Lukey, and Lukey is going to be offside. 7:12 left in the third period. 5-3, a break in the action. We'll pause 30 seconds. This is Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR. We're back at Scope, and the Lancers take the faceoff, come to the blue line, and we've got an offsides against the Lancers with 6:56 to play in the game. Admirals lead it 5-3. Pat Nugent, the general manager, has just dropped by our broadcast table. Pat, congratulations on what's been a great opening night.
Oh, isn't this a tremendous night? I'm just so pleased, and we just got to hang on from here now.
We're going to put you in charge of the last 5 minutes.
All right, I'll take it. Somebody's got to step forward. I'll do it.
Congratulations. It's been a great
thank
night.
Thank you, buddy.
5-3, Admirals lead. They got another wave going here. Shetler really likes the wave. He gets all excited.
Oh, I do. I love the wave. I love the wave.
Here comes the Admirals, and they start to dump it in. Here's Greenberg going in, a shot, and it's high and wide, looking for his fourth goal of the game. Now the Lancers try to control it. Greenberg back behind the net, goes to the corner, gets banged off the puck. A lot of banging going on, and this is picked up now by Chris Lukey. Lukey. He loses it for a moment. Now it's picked up by Wayne Stripp. Stripp is knocked off his skates, and the Lancers clear it out towards center ice. Lancers putting on a 3-on-2 rush. Coming down the wing and in the middle now. It is Waver. Tries to put a shot on goal, but Greenberg shoots at the length of the ice, and that is going to be an icing call against the Admirals, and they'll bring it down to the other end with 6:11 to play in the third period and a 5-3 lead for the Admirals.
Well, certainly the body checking is getting a lot picking up here in the latter part of this period. There's 6:11 remaining. The score 5-3, of course, for the Admirals, and they're certainly putting a tremendous performance on. I noticed that Greenberg again down there, coming in on that left wing, and he's got a bullet of a shot, and he's aiming for that corner all the time. He's picked the corner three times tonight, and he almost hit again for that fourth goal. Now the Lancers win the draw, and a centering pass goes beyond the stick of Waver. Here's a shot, and that goes wide. Lancers still in control, moving in on goal. A shot and a save by Raymond. He keeps it alive in front. The Lancers, and a penalty coming up. And this is going to go against Hampton Roads, and it's going to be for hooking. And a two-minute advantage and a power play for the Lancers coming up. Number three, Buckley, is going to get the tripping call there. So the power play is going to be on again for the Lancers.
But for hooking, number three, David Buckley.
Okay, but we don't care about the penalty, Bob. We just have to care about how Raymond's playing on that goal. I mean, he just made three fantastic professional league, if they were watching anything, and watch the performance of this fellow tonight. And I know that he's borderline to go to the National League anyway. I mean, we would have to be looking at him, because he's got great hands. The Admirals now, I believe, have called a timeout, and we'll take a break. We'll be back in 60 seconds. This is Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR. Welcome back to Scope, everybody. 5:53 to play in the third period, and a 5-3 lead for the Hampton Roads Admirals here on opening night. But now, a power play coming up for the Lancers, and they've got their big guns so far in this game. Paul and Richards have had two men ejected. One is Chigasolo, and he has scored two of the three goals. All right, here's a windup and a shot, and this one is going to be wide by Waver. And the Admirals are able to clear it. Back beyond the blue line. Chelios going back to retrieve it for the Lancers. He plays it ahead to Waver. On the near side at the red line. Puck is stolen by Greenberg. And Stevie unable to take it on in. The Lancers take him off the puck, and here we've got a play coming up the wing, and this is going to be Corvette going in, and this shot is wide. Rebound taken by Denis Paul. Paul playing it behind the Admirals' goal. The Lancers trying to set up the power play here, and Hampton Roads trying to break it up. We've got 5:05 remaining. Chelios outside to Raymond's left. Allen peering through all the defenders there in front of the goal, and here's a really haven't had a shot on goal yet, and a minute has gone in the penalty. Lancers with the power play. Chelios out to the blue line. Fakes the shot. Now plays it over to Waver. He winds up and fires this one high and wide. Kept in on the far side by Corvette. Now back to Waver. Back to Corvette on the right wing. He goes down to the toward the goal line in the corner. And the Admirals are trying to knock that puck away. It's picked up now by the Paul, and he had it knocked away, and now the Admirals bring it up. They've got a man in. Here's a going in. I go a centering pass, but it just goes past the stick of Chris Lukey. Now the Lancers have a rush, and here's a shot, and this one bangs off the back glass. Rebound comes out to the blue line, and the Admirals are going to control it. With 15 seconds left, they're going to kill this penalty. Here's a shot and a save. Right in on goal. Murray Hood with the shot and a save at the midsection by Averill. Lancers now at center ice controlling the puck, and they dump it in. And this one rebounds behind Raymond. The penalty is over to Buckley with 3:45 to play in the game, and the Admirals shoot at the length of the ice. Now, back behind the Lancer goal, and they call icing on Hampton Roads. The power play of the Lancers has a lot to be desired. But really, it's not all the lack of their power play as it is the good defensive play of the Admirals, because the Admirals have been checking that point man and keeping on that lone man. What we have to think of is the manpower advantage. You have that one extra floater that can always have the puck. So if man goes on man, there's always one guy off. So what happens is John Brophy has these guys skating after them, and one man is handling two men. So that looks after that deficit that they have right there.
If you like it to the game of basketball, you're just playing zone defense.
Exactly.
Really, you're packing that zone in around the goal.
Exact same thing.
All right, here come the Lancers in control of the puck, and this one slipped over the boards and out of play, stopping the clock with 3:31 left. 5-3, Hampton Roads leading. Crowd of over 5,600 here at Scope tonight on opening night. Don't forget, we'll be in Benton, Virginia tomorrow night, the Lancer lot for the Lancers home opener. The Admirals in Virginia at 7:30. We'll be on the air at 7:15 tomorrow night. Here's the draw, and it's won by the Lancers, and they have it in the far corner, and with it there is Richards. Now the puck comes behind, and the centering pass goes wild, and it's picked out of there by Chris Luke, and the Admirals start up the wing. Coming up the near side, here's Murray Hurd going in on goal. Murray taken to the corner by the defense, and the Lancers knock it away, and back with it now is Whitfield, and he spins down Chris Luke. The Lancers have it. Here's a fake on the slap shot. The drop past the slot. Wind up. Saved by Raymond. On a powerful slap shot that time by Hobson. Here's a pass coming to the near wing, and the Admirals are starting to get something going. Here's Greenberg. It's a two-on-one. Greenberg is in. Centering pass. A shot. A backhand. A save by Averett. 2:40 to play in the game, and 5-3 the Admirals lead. The Lancers are starting to clear it. Boy, I'll tell you, this crowd pulse quickens when Greenberg gets his stick on the puck. He's going to be a favorite. Now back behind the goal, Raymond clears it out, and he gets it up ahead to Wasine. Wasine coming to his own blue line. Great cross-ice pass, and this one now is going to be intercepted by the Lancers in Whitfield. Over to Chelios. 2:15 left. 5-3 is the score. The Admirals are on top. Raymond shoots this one out of the zone, and it is picked up by the Lancers. They are able to keep it in. Admirals jamming things up on the near corner. Here's the puck now, and it's shot out of the Virginia end, and up it goes toward the goal, and with it there is Averill. And it is going to be, here's a shot and a save by Averill. The Admirals are trying to keep it in. And we've got the play coming to the blue line, and Greenberg steals the puck. Greenberg with a shot and a glove save by Averill. And the Lancers now with a minute 24 to go. Down two goals. Things are looking better now for the Admirals as they try to salt this one away and win their inaugural game. On the right side, it is Denis Paul. Paul looking around. And now they sing it the length of the ice, and that will be icing called on the Admirals. And that stops the clock with a minute four to play and a 5-3 lead for Hampton Roads.
Well, we have 1 minute remaining, Bob, and the fans are really not leaving. It's amazing, you know, with a two-goal lead like that, people would think they're going to win it, but they're wanting to see every last skate of the blade out there.
it's been a great night, no doubt about it. We'll be talking with the number one star, who won this game as history. The Lancers have taken a timeout, so let's pause. 30 seconds for this break. This is Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR. We are back at Scope. A minute four remaining. With the Admirals leading Virginia 5-3. Pat Chubba will be talking with John Brophy, and our number one star, Warner Hessler of the Daily Press, is making the selection tonight for the three stars of the game, the Texaco star of the game. And we'll be speaking with that gentleman as soon as this one is over. 5-3, the Admirals on top. And here's a shot and a save by Raymond. It's, where is it? In the slot, and it's kicked out of there. Here's a save by Taylor. And I think he took one in the face, Patty. Maybe the puck or the stick, but he tried to smother that shot by Corvette. And I think that puck one up and may have gotten him in the chops.
Really? Some of the greatest thing they've ever invented in hockey are the mouth guards and the helmets and so forth. Years ago, of course, they never wore those, and there were a lot of injuries. But now he could have been injured much, much worse than he was. He wasn't injured really in that play, but he could have been by the puck flashing around in underneath his close to his Adam's apple.
5-3 Admirals, 54 seconds left. And here is a Chelios quick shot knocked away by the defense. And the Admirals hit it out to center ice, lunging after it was Scott Taylor just to get rid of that puck. And now the Lancers trying to put some more heat on the Admirals here and close within the goal. But the Admiral defense puts it out to center ice. And here's Chelios. Chelios putting it in and dumping it in, and the Lancers keep it in at the blue line. Now a shot on goal. This one goes wide of Ramona toward the corner. Kayla there to get it for the Admirals. 25 seconds. Matt Shetler is headed downstairs. Looks like the Admirals are going to do it. Win their opener. Now play time is called. And it is going to be sides against Virginia. 16 seconds left and a standing ovation for the Admirals. Remain. Admirals lead it 5-3. And we've got a face-off at center ice, and Steve Greenberg will be doing the honors for the Admirals, and he wins the draw at the center ice. And here's a shot, and empty net, the goal! Chris Lukey in the empty net makes it 6-3. With the empty net goal, the Lancers had pulled their goaltender, Averill, at that last break to get an extra defender, and Lukey burns them immediately. That makes it 6-3. So Chris Lukey gets into the scoring column. He also has 2 assists in this game. So Lukey with 3 points and his first goal of the season. 6-3. Admirals lead, 7 seconds, 6. That's going to do it. Chelios goes behind the goal, 3 seconds, 2. It's all over. The Admirals have won their inaugural game. The final score tonight, Admirals 6 and the Virginia Lancers 3. We will be back with more hockey from Scope in 30 seconds. This is Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR. Welcome back to Scope, the final. The Virginia Lancers 6, or the Hampton Roads Admirals 6 and the Virginia Lancers 3. Shots on goal in the third period. Virginia with 9. And that gives them a total of 37 for the night. The Admirals had 13 shots on goal, and they end up with 41 tonight. The Admirals with the 3 goals in the second period, 3 in the third. And 6-3 is the final in this one. Here are the stars of the game. The third star tonight was goaltender of the Admirals, Alain Raymond, who did a whale of a job in the pipes tonight. The number 2 star of the game for the Lancers is Mike Tigasola, who was ejected in the third period. And the number 1 star, our Texaco star of the game from the Admirals, a hat trick.
All right, yeah. So you're American boy making it big.
American boy.
Well, you really had some good shots on goal, and the big thing about it is you were aiming the puck for where it should go, and that's the corners.
Yeah, that's the only way to score in this league. You got to really hit the corners because the goalies are great in this league.
Yeah, your goaltender did a fine job there tonight, too. I think it was a full effort from everybody, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. I think everyone did the best job. That's why we won. Not one man can do anything, and the goalie is unbelievable. He's one of the best, and yeah, that's why he's there.
Yeah, by all means. Well, you certainly had a fine game there tonight. You were certainly a great first star.
Well, thank you.
And I think there's a lot of good things coming.
I think so. I think this whole team has a lot of good things coming.
I do, too. And John Brophy is going to keep you guys right on hand.
That's why we're going to win.
Okay. Nice talking to you, Steve. Okay, Pat. We're trying to get a hold of John, and I see John over in the far side, and I'd like to have a little chat with him. John, congratulations, boy. They did a super job there tonight.
Look at the roving mic here.
Look at the roving mic, boy. The roving mic.
Yeah, it was a great win for us.
The boys, they cannot work any harder than that. And the end is what I like most about it was the discipline we showed and not getting caught 3-2s or 2-1s. And I thought overall, once we got ahead, I love the way we killed the clock off.
Yeah, they had a lot of power plays. And, of course, it wasn't their lack of the power play, but it was your defensive work that did a fine job.
We got some penalties in the middle there. Excited there and get a little hyper going for the middle of the third period, but there was a couple of penalties, but they're good penalties. They're aggressive, and then they just happened to get called. We killed them off well, and great goaltending, number one.
Oh, yeah, tremendous goaltending. What about the second period? At the end of the first period, you seemed to be lacking a little faster. It might have been that the legs weren't, with the lack of training camp, maybe the legs weren't there.
Right.
But in the second period, look at the way they came out.
That's right, and I think that we started to come out quickly, and they got a score, and then we came back, tied it up, and we kind of set back a little bit. In the second period, we came out, and we could see when you score in the first minute of the period, that makes the period.
And
whoever scores and takes over the first 5 minutes of the period makes the period. We took over with the and got them back, and we picked it up from there. We just played great, I thought.
Yeah, certainly the crowd was great tonight.
We're into the game, and I think that we continue to hustle and hit and work like that, we'll have some people in this building.
Oh, I certainly think you will. You had a great crowd tonight. You did a fine job, and the hockey players did a fine job also.
Absolutely. I mean, that's the ones that did the fine job.
That's right.
And it was easy to just sit back and roll them out because everybody was working.
All right. Thanks again, John, and congratulations tonight.
Thank you very much.
And now we'll take it back upstairs.
Okay. Thank you, Pat Shetler. 6-3, the final. We'll be back with more from Scope as our wrap-up continues on opening night right after these messages. Back in 60 seconds, this is Admirals Hockey on WTAR.
He's a nice young guy. He's a big
boy. Welcome back to Scope, everybody. The final score again tonight was the Admirals 6 and the Virginia Lancers 3. And a reminder that the Admirals will make a $10 contribution to Special Olympics for each goal scored this season, so the Admirals will put $60 towards that fund today. Three of the goals scored by our number one star of the game, Steve Greenberg, you heard moments ago with Pat Shetler, and also Hampton Roads' goals tonight. Wayne Stripp had one, Prasnick had one, then the empty net goal by Lukey to make it a 6-3 final tonight here at Scope. 5,602 the attendance tonight, and everybody went home happy as the Admirals win it. And in pretty impressive fashion, Pat, when you consider this club just coming together in a week or 10 days, really. They had a couple of exhibition games, but really those are hard to gauge because so many players have come and gone since then. And really this is the first time that John's been able to put this hand-picked 16 on the ice tonight, and I thought they did a marvelous job.
Yeah, when I talked to John earlier in the evening prior to the game, he said that he didn't know what he had there. He wasn't really too excited about it, but now, and after interviewing him down there at the end of the game, he was certainly excited, and he's very proud of the team, and I think there's bigger and better things to come.
Well, one thing about the professional sports, you don't have long to enjoy it.
That's for sure.
Right on the road tomorrow night, we'll be in Vinton to take on the Lancers, and then Sunday night we'll be in Johnstown to meet the Chiefs, so enjoy it tonight because it's back to work tomorrow.
By all means, Bob.
Okay.
It was enjoyable tonight.
Pat, thank you.
Thank you.
Enjoyed it immensely. A lot of fun. They called Bill Chadwick the Big Whistle. We got to come up with a nickname for you.
That's right.
We'll work on that for Wednesday with Niles.
The Red Whistle.
All right. So, the final score again tonight from Scope was the Hampton Roads Admirals 6 and the Virginia Lancers 3. Hampton Roads Admirals Hockey on WTAR brought to you by US Air, America's frequent flyer, by Home Quarters Warehouse, Picosa Leasing, the leasing professionals, and by Texaco. You can trust your car to the man who wears the star. Once again, our final, the Admirals 6 and the Lancers 3 will be on the air tomorrow night, 7:15 from Vinton, Virginia, with the pregame show, 7:30 face-off, and then we'll be leaving you at World Series Game 4, tape delay coverage of the final two periods after the baseball tomorrow night. So for Pat Shetler, this is Bob Rathbun from Scope, and for this Friday night, so long, everybody.